We're back on. Can y'all tell me if you can hear the music and me and everything is good and stuff? It's gonna keep turning on and off while I move out of the window and stuff. Y'all can hear it? Can you hear it? Can you hear it? Can you hear it? Please tell me you can hear it. Yeah, now I gotta wait like the 10. Alright, music is in there. You're there. Awesome. Alright, can I edit the scene while I'm trying to... Yeah, here we go. Alright, I want to move this. People said this was a little too... Can I move that? Is that good? I'll move me. I'll move me over here. Hello. This all looks silly. That's fine. Okay. This good? This good. Okay, we're keeping it. We're keeping it. Alright, how do I... Okay, X out of that. All right. Okay, so you see my little Twitter handle down there, Dave's Golden Voice. I'm going to quickly tweet and say that I got all the technical problems working, and y'all can come back. So I'm going to do that. Okay, I'm just going to quickly tweet. I got the technical problems fixed, so feel free to come back to the stream! Exclamation point. www.twitch.tv/WajidIGames. And if you guys wouldn't mind tweeting about it as well, I would really appreciate that. I am trying to, you know, figure this whole Twitch thing out and build some kind of an audience. Don't jinx it, right? The final issue, it was that when the microphone is plugged in, it changes the speaker to come out of the microphone. And I thought I had selected that option, but it wouldn't take effect until I started the stream over. So that's what happened. Thank you. Cue a Windows mandatory update. I already have Windows 10. They can't give it to me again. All right. So has anyone come back to the stream? All right. 9 people. Hurrah. Okay. So my computer's over this way, so I'm not looking at you guys like most streamers do. All right. So let's do this. Let's do this. So I, the reason why I'm doing this is I recompiled Blackwell Legacy in the latest version of Adventure Game Studio. The game's very old and it's starting to have a lot of compatibility issues. The way AGS used to work is that even though the games are low resolution, most monitors could still handle those low resolutions, and so it would force your monitor to switch to the new resolution, which is dumb in modern times, because monitors are much bigger these days. So forcing like a 1080p monitor to shrink down to 320 by 200 was a lot to ask for a monitor. So the newest version of AGS scales things up in the smarter way, where it makes the game scale up instead of making your monitor scale down. So that's why a lot of people were having annoying resolution and glitchy issues with it. Also, mouse acceleration was annoying. So I thought I'd finally recompile it in the newest version of AGS. And it ran, so that's all good. And I figured I have to test it now. So that's why I'm doing this stream. I figure, why test alone? So there might be some weird bug that I don't know about. Maybe the game will crash as soon as I hit the new game button, in which case this stream will be even shorter. And all of that technical stuff was a big waste of time. All right, pressing it now, pressing it now. Here we go, moment of truth. Bam. Pfft, did I really do this? Oh my god, 2006 Dave. Come on. Alright.
So, I guess this is it. Years of watching and waiting and hoping, and it comes down to this.
Rebecca.
Do I love you? Do I miss you? I don't know for sure, I hardly know you. But you're the closest thing to family I've got, and I suppose that's something. Goodbye, Auntie.
Down.
Wherever you are.
Glorious beginning of a fantastic series. I remember when I made this introduction, I thought it was like the coolest thing ever, because no EGS game had ever done it before, and this is all just like, since the poster for the game was done at a really, really high resolution, I just took bits of the poster, and this is just moving the camera around bits of the poster. So that's all that is. Cars blow are hit by a spray of ash. Yep. I still remember the music. I haven't played this in 5 years when I re-released it 5 years ago. Was it 5 years ago? It's 2011. 6 years ago! Ah! 6 years ago, oh my god, look at that. Dave, how did I let this happen? Oh my god! I don't know if that's a new AGS thing or not, but if it's not, I should be ashamed of myself. Alright, that's something I gotta fix. Anyway. Yeah, I sort of redid the game about 6 years ago, in the current new version of AGS, because I was hoping to get it onto Steam, and as a result I did a couple of interesting things where I re-recorded Rosa Blackwell's voice with the new actress who played her in the later games, just to keep things consistent. I felt bad about that, but... at that point, Rebecca Whitaker was kind of cemented in my head as Rosa, and hearing Sandy Chen, with all due respect to her, she was a fine actress, but her voice wasn't Rosa to me anymore. So I recast her, or rather I re-recorded it with the new Rosa. Anyway, let's continue on. Oh, yes.
Hi there.
Hi.
So who are you visiting?
Plot twist, today? Rosa's a ghost as well.
Oh, the
funny thing is,
the
doorman. His name is Matt Gardner, and he actually did the original sketch concepts for Rosa and Joey. So you have him to thank for the iconic look of all the characters.
Really
nice. I know everyone in this building,
and
I don't
know
you. Sorry.
I've lived here for 5.
Then how come I've never seen you before?
I have no idea. Doesn't matter.
If you played the commentary for the original, for the 5 year, if you played one of the commentaries for this game, you've heard me complain about the sequence.
How come nobody told me?
You lived here, you'd have seen him.
If y'all want
to
listen
like
carefully to the dialogue, you can buy the game. This is not a good introduction to a long-running series, and I fully admit that.
I'll be back.
Hello.
How long is this strike going to last?
I don't know. Could be a couple hours or a couple days. Depend on whether they reach a settlement or not. I don't know the details.
Oh, Matt.
Please, I've had a really tough morning. I need to get home.
Sorry, lady. Rules are rules.
Listen, I really live here. Fourth floor, number 4E.
4E actually happened to be my old apartment number.
PC.
You have any ID? A driver's license or something?
Yes. I have a driver's license. It's upstairs. In my desk drawer.
Well, that angry portrait of Rosa's really mean.
Come on, this is New York. Who actually drives?
This is true.
True. But I still can't let you in unless you prove you live here.
I haven't driven regularly in about 20 years. Threaten violence, Jesus, Dave.
Out of my way. I'm going in.
I wouldn't do that.
Why? Are you going to stop me?
Me? No. But I've got a cell phone in my pocket.
I have a feeling this whole thing is just going to be going, going to be me going, oh,
are you serious?
Did I really do that?
Totally serious.
Did I really do that?
I don't believe this.
People always tell me I'm extraordinarily hard on myself when it comes to, when it comes to Blackwell Legacy.
I have my apartment key. Will that do?
I'm glad enough
of you like the
game.
Well, let's go upstairs and
because all I can see are the things I would have done differently, or
can't do it. Sorry.
Or the flaws, or the long dialogues, and the fact that I apparently I didn't activate the play idle animations while dialogue is up option because he stopped smoking.
Okay, I have no ID, and you don't know me. What can I...
Yeah, I'm Sasha, that is fixed in the latest version of AGS. The Steam overlay will still come up, but you won't be able to use it. That's I haven't quite gotten that far. You can see it, you just can't use it. And but it doesn't screw up the game anymore, which is a step in the right direction. Ask about Nishanti.
Who is this Nis?
Nishanti lives in 4F, you know, right next door to 4E. You really don't get out much, do you?
Your point?
Nothing, but I'm sure she could vouch for you.
Great, call her up.
Artists tend
here.
To be
hard
on their old art.
You're
no kidding,
all
yeah.
Day for her.
I mean, you have to
I
be.
Have to. Although, she usually goes to Washington Square Park. You can look for her there.
Restate the obvious.
I'll be back.
Take your leave.
See you.
I remember thinking that was so clever at the time, making the dialogue options incredibly vague. You know, take your leave, restate the obvious. And I guess it's cool. It's better than just having word for word what you're going to say, and then the character just parrots it right back. But I remember trying to be a little... I was a little too clever about it, maybe. The only puzzle that I never liked is when we first meet Moti, Nishanti's dog. That puzzle I never minded too much. A lot of people had trouble with it. I hated coding it. If you listen to the commentary, you'll hear my trials and tribulations about how I coded that dog. Speaking of which, if something's going to break in this new version of the game, that's going to be it. It's going to be that stupid dog. Because it uses these raw draw functions that always get updated and changed. Ooh, the outline opacity Photoshop trick. Yay, you can tell I was working on a budget back then. Ha! Oh my god, I could see some cheap trick that I did. You see what happens when I bring the mouse to the top of the screen? Bam! That's because the inventory interface is actually invisibly coming down. But I apparently couldn't figure out how to remove it completely, so instead I just made it invisible. Oh man. That was cheap. Well, I'm pulling back the curtain here, guys. That's what I'm doing. Okay, so we go to Washington Square Park. I used to live right here.
Washington Square. It's been a while since I've been here. Still looks the same, I guess. Although
it's not a coincidence that most of the Blackwell locations are like 5 minutes away from where I used to live. Washington Square Park was literally about... It was 3 blocks from where I used to live, and I used to always love going there. And I was looking after this dog, a Boston Terrier that looks strangely enough a lot like Moti. I used to walk him here every day. So I have a lot of memories of this place. Oh, this sign is actually a very low-res version of my face. You can't tell, but that's me. It's the show that adventure game designers don't want you to see. The one dialogue choice that was presented as sarcastic, deadpan, and paranoid was when I decided that I loved everything about this game and needed to play the series with me. Well, thank you. I'm glad. You know, it's... Often back then, I thought I was just being too clever for my own good, but I'm glad people liked it. Maybe I should go back to doing that. Now I won't be able to unsee that. You're welcome. Let's go.
Now I'm getting a stress headache. I need to get home.
Ooh, the music volume dips when she talks. That's something I gotta look at. Oh, wait. Is that walk behind working? Yes, it is. Okay. Hello, Moti. Wow, the puzzle literally just solved itself. Look at that. He just walked around the pole. The puzzle just solved itself. I didn't have to do a thing. Well... Okay, hey, look, the dog, the leash is working. You know, I'm actually really, really glad that Moti is black. Because the leash is actually going over Moti right there. So I'm really glad he's black, because that helped. I love how you used a lot of real-life locations that made me want to travel to New York. That was actually my goal when I first made this game. I wanted to kind of do for New York what Gabriel Knight did for New Orleans. So I'm glad I was successful. My English wasn't prepared for this. All right.
That's her. I recognize her from my building. Nishanti Sharma, was it? This is going to be awkward.
That's the Washington Square Arch, which Actually, this background extends, and I'm like going like this, and I'm looking over here, and I see that you can't actually see my hand. The background actually extends quite a bit beyond this point. You can see where my cursor is. You'd be able to see the arch if you could actually walk over there. I stupidly didn't let you. It didn't enable you to do that, so you can't see the arch. So that was dumb. Anyway.
Excuse. I can't do it. I can't just barge up to her. Not in front of all those people. They're all staring.
I remember when I recorded this, re-recorded this rather, with Rebecca Whitaker, and it was all done out of order, because she recorded Blackwell Convergence, then she recorded Blackwell Deception, and then she recorded Blackwell Legacy, and she always knew Rosa was kind of awkward, but she was really surprised at how awkward she was in this game. So that was an interesting kind of paradigm shift for her. Okay, Mooty. Yeah, the Boston Terrier I used to have, his name was Cooper, and looked a lot like this, as I said. Here we go.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Don't worry, Moti, I'm coming.
I'm still sad you renamed it from Bestowers of Eternity. I'm not. That was a really stupid title. I'd prefer this.
They're all better.
At least I thought it was stupid.
I can't take you
anywhere. I'm like really down on myself, aren't I? Everything I did more than 5 years ago is horrible.
The lady next door.
No, that was a stupid title.
Hi,
I think it's stupid because I came up with it.
No, Rosangela.
Everything I came up with or created more than 5 years ago, I can't.
I hope my friend here hasn't been giving you any trouble.
It's the artist's dilemma. All right, let's see here.
He started following me. I'm not sure why.
Some people...
That's because he recognizes you.
Taking a video on a flip phone.
See?
That was really, really high tech in 2006 when this came out.
I'm Nishanti.
Rosangela.
So you said.
Oh, right.
Yes?
People should take Black Bull tour.
Go ahead and ask. What are neighbors for?
A Black Bull tour would actually not take very long.
Yes.
Because most of it is 5 minutes from this place.
That's the problem, see? He doesn't recognize me.
Oh, so you need me to vouch for you?
Yeah, I know this is pretty stupid.
Don't worry about it. Moti is getting a little cranky anyway. Let's get you home.
Thanks.
So, when I'm talking over the characters, is the sound mix okay? Should I make one of them louder or one of them softer or anything like that?
I'm fine. I just need to
get... Good choice for the name of the main character?
Let's
Rosa Blackwell? Thank you. I assume that's who you're talking about. Notice there's no leash anymore.
Hello, Jim.
Hey, Miss Sharma.
I'm really amazed that in all this time, no one's ever called me out on that.
Earlier. Had to be sure.
Angry. Syrupy sweet.
Oh, it was no problem at all. Do you want anything else? Milk or orange juice, perhaps? Never mind. Just get out of my way.
That seemed like such a burn 10 years ago when I wrote that.
Well, here we are.
I could write so much better insults now.
Finally. That stupid kid.
Well, perhaps. But try not to be so hard on him. We're all neighbors after all.
Moti was very well behaved. Cooper
Looks
was
like
not.
Somebody's hungry. I'd best get this spoiled puppy fed. Feel free to drop in anytime you want.
I had to remove the leash as it caused so many problems. Yes. I did not want to have to deal with a walking character, a walking dog, and a leash that had to move between them. Nope. Surprised, polite, uncertain. Polite.
I'll think about it.
No thinking needed. I know we New Yorkers don't usually talk to our neighbors, but who cares? The city can be a lonely place, especially when you live alone. I've got Moti. Who do you have?
Try to make a joke. This is a very true-to-life kind of thing. I think that's if I'm proud of anything. I know I'm very hard on myself when it comes to this game, but if I'm very proud of anything is that I was really trying to kind of recreate the New York experience, at least the way I was living it at the time. It's even though you're in a city, it's very easy to isolate yourself. And I was very much kind of experiencing that and kind of reinventing that with Rosa Blackwell. I guess I tweeted the wrong stream link. Did I tweet the wrong stream link? Let me look at Twitter. Ah, wrong link. God darn it. Okay. Oops. All right. Apparently I need to do HTTPS. Let me just retweet that. All right. Whoops. Exclamation point. The correct link for the stream is that. Okay. Someone wrote wrong link bra. Do people actually say that? I guess they do. Okay. The previous one worked. All right, here we go. Try to make a joke.
Oh, I have three great roommates.
Oh?
Yes. Their names are me, myself, and I.
Okay, you know what? That joke was funny. I'll take credit for that.
It's a joke.
That.
Yeah, I get it. Very funny. I'm sure you're fine. Although your episode in the park tells me otherwise. And your eyes. Well, let's just
How
say
can you
the
see
offer
your eyes
stands.
Through those glasses?
Sure. You go home now. We'll see each other soon, Rosangela, I'm sure.
Hey.
Yes?
You can call me Rosa, if you like. Rosangela's kind
you know,
of a mouthful,
all I can think
you know?
Of about this scene is that there is no music, no background
right,
noise,
Rosa,
noise, no room tone. That's all I can think of now.
What a strange lady.
You know, if I regret anything... Oh, no footstep. No footstep sounds either. I have come a long way in terms of my, I don't know, professionalism or whatever. I was about to say something very profound, and I completely forgot what it was. I do regret, and I've mentioned this before, that I never did anything with Nishanti, did I? I kind of forgot about her, and I didn't forget about her so much as kind of ignored her, because I... my original plan for her, my original story arc or big reveal for her, I realized was really, really dumb. The big reveal was that she was Lauren Blackwell's neighbor as well, 30 years earlier. And that was it. It was really, really stupid. It was a really, really dumb reveal. And I didn't want to use it. I didn't want to do it because it was dumb. But I had already established Nishanti and Moti as characters, and I tried to come up with something else to do with her, but I never got there. I never could think of anything that didn't seem forced, so I just kind of quietly put her on a bus. In every game, she was just kind of traveling somewhere, and she never got the screen time she deserved, so I always felt bad about that. It's the problem with a long-running series like this. You tend to run into those problems. Would you be playing Unbound as well? Yes, I will. I will be playing every single one of our games, really. I'm recompiling everything in the latest version of AGS. Okay, let's go home. Ooh, I like this song.
Home. Thank God.
Thank God.
I've never been so happy to see a 500-square-foot room in my life.
Ugh. Analog phone, man. That's old school. She's even got a 3x4 monitor.
Hello?
This is Dr. Quentin from Bellevue Hospital.
Yes?
I was your aunt's primary care physician. Did you receive my letter?
Yes, I received it.
Okay,
I haven't had the time to come by.
Yeah, I'm going to try to get them on
That's all
YouTube.
Right. I'm sure you're busy.
Hopefully
However,
it works. I know it archives the video for like
I sure
for
I'll
like
keep
2
that
weeks.
In mind.
Thank you. Good day.
If I don't visit him, he's just going to keep bothering me. I suppose I should just get it over with.
You expected to have VHSs instead of DVDs. It was 2006. I always imagined Rosa as having There we go. I always imagined, whenever it came to, like, fashion or anything, I always envisioned Rosa as being 5 years behind the times. So it's like, in 2006, I was thinking, like, in 2001, this outfit was kind of popular. A lot of girls were wearing this around the turn of the millennium, so I figured that's what she should wear. So that's... if you look at the year any Blackwell game came out, the year I started working on any Blackwell game, I always looked at fashions that were popular from like 5 years previously, and that's what I based her clothes on. Oh God, look at that. She like merges into that door. It's all these little things that I nitpick now in my own games or other games that I publish that I would just, I'm seeing in this game and I'm like, I would never allow myself to do this now. But, you know, whatever. Oh God, Griff the bear.
That's Griff, the PI bear. I've had him as long as I can remember. He's in horrible shape, but I don't have the heart to throw him away.
Griff is actually based on the first original character I ever created for a freeware game. It was this detective named Max Griff. Has anyone in the stream played the Max Griff game? It was a Reality on the Norm game, so I had to reference him here. And my original idea was that, like, since her auntie Lauren wanted to prepare Rosa for being a bestower later in life, she gave her this teddy bear with the hat and tie, and which kind of looked like Joey, so to sort of prepare her for it.
It's a photograph of Auntie Lauren and me.
These close-ups were drawn by a guy named... they were sketched by Matt Gardner, the guy who played Jimberto the doorman. Postman only dies once. Yeah, of course you would know it, Francisco. And hey, Francisco, how many people are in the stream now? Let me move some windows. 40 people! Sweet, okay. These were sketched by Matt Gardner, and they were colored by a guy named E.L. Jammer? Or E.L. Yammer? Something like that. He was J-A-M-M-E-R. I never learned how to pronounce his name because I only talked to him on the internet. I wonder what happened to him, because he was a very good artist, and I kind of lost touch with him. I feel bad about that. Anyway. That's so cute. I'm so glad. Mika was hilarious. Oh, yeah. I had a lot of fun writing that. That Postman only dies once. It was a very weird time in my life, and it was a good thing to write. Anyway. By the way, I'm getting over a flu. I'm, like, just getting over it. Like, today's the first day I feel human. So my voice is a little scratchy and stuff. You can write and watch on the side. I'm not supposed to be. Okay, so I answered the phone already. So letter. Whoa, fuzzy text. Oh my god, Dave. Would never let myself get away with this now. I wouldn't let Francisco get away with it when he did it in Shardlight. Alright. Oh come on, Dave, you can't use the remote. Anyway, let's leave. Haven't even noticed your voice at all, Dave, so no worries. It's like, no, your voice is always that annoying. Come on. Let's leave. Hey, she doesn't even go into the elevator. How cheap was that? Okay. Yeah. Are you coming to the drink night tonight? No, I'm not. I think I'm still maybe a little sick. Janet's going instead. I know, I gotta go. It seems like Janet's been my social proxy for every event that's been going on. But I was hers for a very long time, so it evens out. God, the design of this room is really weird. It's like going back and looking at these designs is just... The guy who did these backgrounds, and what I'm noticing is that he kind of, like, cheated by using only a small section of the screen. The guy who did these backgrounds... Oh, yeah, Francisco's cameo is coming. Thanks for the stream, Dave, and for the great games. Oh, you're welcome, Hatnix? You're hosting me. Thank you. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, the guy who originally did these backgrounds disappeared. Like, he just disappeared. He did, like... They were all in various stages of completion, and then he just disappeared. And I still hadn't even paid him yet, and he had just disappeared. Like, I didn't have his address or phone number, which, you know, maybe I should have gotten, but he disappeared completely. And I had to get someone at the very last minute to redo them all. So yeah, he kind of left me high and dry, because I was really determined to get this game out by, like, I think December 23rd it was. And I did make it in the end. But he kind of really screwed me over, that guy. I even forget his name. He was Norwegian, that's all I remember. Anyway, let's talk to Francisco here.
I'm here to see Dr. Quentin.
Uh-huh. Is he expecting you?
The artist was a ghost the whole time.
Okay, looks legit.
The artist was a ghost, yes.
His name's on the door.
Perspective sort of magically fuses in the center of the room. That might be it. I mean, I don't know much about art, but we need to get Ben to do one of his whatchamacallits.
Dr. Quentin?
His art.
Yes.
I'm Rosangela
theory,
Blackwell.
Art analysis,
oh,
things of it.
Come in.
That is.
You got my letter.
Very interesting pose, Dr. Quentin.
Yes, I did.
Good. My condolences on the loss of your mother.
Oh, the guy who does his voice. He also did the voice of the director in Gemini Rue. Joe is an amazing actor. I kind of went off working remotely with actors. Otherwise, I would keep using Joe. He lives a bit far away. He was a part of my improv group way back when. And I loved working with him. He was just a really funny guy. And yet, I always seemed to give him these very somber, serious type of roles to play because he's got that kind of voice. And he's got this like purple jacket. I don't get it. Yeah. I don't know. What was I going to say? Yeah, that's Joe. Also, the music. Peter Gresser, who's Matt Gardner's partner, he told me that the clock ticking is in reference to a puzzle in the original freeware game of this, Bestowers of Eternity, from which I've tried to scour from the internet. In that game, in the hospital, there's this really stupid puzzle where you need to play with a stopwatch alarm, and he said that this was a reference to that. I do like the ticking. It's really cool. Stern correction, polite or subtle? Let's be subtle.
Thanks. My aunt is at peace now.
That is my wife walking in the background there.
Quite right.
So you wanted to talk to me about something?
Yes, I did. But before we go into that, how are you holding up?
Cautious response. I guess these are clever, and I know some of you said earlier that you really like these kind of vague options, but they are a little vague, aren't they? I tried to be a little less vague about them later. Anyway,
just having a really bad morning.
Oh?
I'll get over it. Just some stuff I have to deal with.
You received the ashes?
Yes. I scattered them this morning.
I imagine you must miss her.
Not exactly. Set up properly. Kendrick. Husband? No way! Oh my god! Dr. Quentin will remember this. This predates The Walking Dead by about 4 years. I was ahead of my time. I should sneak that in. Paranoid response. Let's be paranoid. We are in a mental hospital.
Why does it matter?
There I go again. Asking so many questions.
God, Joe,
you're
such
not a patient. You came at my request.
Listen to that. Remotely.
Right.
He did that remotely.
Auntie was the patient.
It's so hard
to,
like,
me
have that warmth and just genuine, that genuineness when you work remotely. It's just, he's really, really good. Joe Rodriguez is his name. I'm getting a husband in a couple of days. Oh, well, congratulations, Rosella. None of your business. Let's be mean to this guy. He's kind of a jerk, isn't he?
I don't see why it's any business of yours.
It's all right. Forget I asked.
I wanted to come. I came.
Ooh.
That's all.
Back in the day, I did the whole two spaces after period thing.
Auntie's dead.
I don't
life
do that anymore.
On.
I read somewhere that it was wrong.
Yes.
Keep writing your little book reviews in the paper, right?
You know about those?
It's hardly a secret. A number of the staff have read them, yes.
I didn't think a West Village paper would interest anyone up here.
I have to be honest, Miss Blackwell. The staff read them because they were more interested in you.
The PI bear with me. Defensive.
Okay, I am this close to leaving.
And I don't blame you.
Why am I here?
They're in...
God,
it was
forever.
Your aunt. They wanted to know more about
I now
her
call
family.
This doctor... I call this guy now Dr. Infodump. Because he just talks a long, long time. I would never design a scene like
That's
this now.
That's their problem.
Never
Indeed.
In a million years.
Your aunt was in...
I really try to limit dialogue
case.
Now.
And now that
but people
gone,
say they like it. People still say they love it. I am very hard on
just
Blackwell. I'm very hard on... Well, Blackwell Legacy
specifically.
I'm very, very hard on it. And I know that more than anyone. So if I'm supposed to be using these streams to like promote myself, right? To make, you know, to make people like my stuff. And yet here I am going, oh no, this sucks. I wouldn't do that. Oh my God, Brett, what am I? So yeah, I suck at this apparently. I still want to read Joe Gold's Secret. Good. It's a very good book. It's a very, very good book. It's a movie. It's also a movie. I don't know where you're based, but it's on American Netflix, I think.
Wait, what do you mean by my condition?
Hereditary, it's really good.
I had no idea.
Well, maybe you should have. Did anyone
it
else
It was one of my biggest inspirations. It actually inspired
a lot of Blackwell. I should have read the family.
Mostly because I actually went to the Mineta Tavern and I would do my writing and designing there.
Well, never mind.
The book is
change the fact.
The book is better, but the movie is still good.
Go on.
Patricia Blackwell suffered her mental collapse at the age of 55. Lauren Blackwell underwent hers at the age of 40.
The one thing I learned about too much dialogue, which I'm going to turn the volume down here just a touch so you can hear me.
I'm saying that there is significant cause for concern.
The one thing I've learned about, excuse me, I'm still hacking up a lung, about long dialogues in games, especially like this, is, I mean, if you look at them, it's just like, Rose has got her back to the camera, number one. I always tell designers now that is really, really bad blocking. Never have your character with their back to the camera, especially when you have a dialogue as long as this one. Because no matter how interesting the dialogue is, and even though it's long, I still do think it's interesting. I think it's interesting dialogue, but it goes on for a very long time. But what you're seeing on the screen is this static image. Nothing changes. So it's gonna get boring. That's just something I've learned over the years. And even though I'm glad y'all managed to see through this 11 years ago when you played this game.
You never could find out what was wrong with her, huh?
No, we didn't. But she still remains a fascinating...
Susan Sarandon? She's a big star.
I don't understand.
Forgive me. I speak from a purely professional perspective. I didn't know your aunt personally.
Neither did I. But fascinating?
It might come as a surprise.
The close-ups helps.
But yes.
And their lips move in the earlier games.
All she did
games.
Was lie there for 20 years.
I stopped doing that.
Right. She had outbursts.
Because...
Yes, and... We had
it
to
was
her
really difficult
call,
to.
Especially in preparation
excuse me.
For your visits.
It was expensive for the artists to do.
Blackwell, we're not
and
to
we could have much more interesting, vibrant portraits
are, all,
if they didn't have to animate.
To heal
the lip flaps definitely keep you visually
that,
engaged. Well, good.
We
some
Wait,
people would go so far
to
as to make the to make the lips lip sync with the voiceover. I didn't go that far because that's just way too much work for like a very kind of superficial change. I was so upset when they stopped. I'm sorry. I did it for a reason. I just couldn't justify the expense and time. You know, we're on a budget. We don't have infinite money. I would love to do that if I had more money to spend than I do. Anyway.
If Auntie spoke, why wasn't I told?
Miss Blackwell, do you remember what brought your aunt here in the first place? Her screaming? Her hitting herself?
I was only 5 years, but I kind of
There's some
remember.
Things that if you don't have in a game like this, I think are deal breakers with the fans and the audience. I don't think,
when
like, talking portraits
she simply reverted
is one of them.
State.
That's not one of them.
Her natural state, I'm sorry to add.
What did Auntie say?
Nothing that made any sense.
Well, thank
but
you.
One thing was clear. She was in great pain.
Pain? What kind of pain?
Oh my God, they're still talking.
It's difficult to say, but it was...
How immense?
When we reduced her medication, the transformation was dramatic. Her eyes flew
favorite
open.
Favorite portraits are from Epiphany. They're my favorite, too. I really like those. Ian did an amazing job with those portraits.
We had to gag her eventually.
Oh my God.
I know.
Did she still feel it when she was sedated?
We don't know. There's no way of knowing.
25 years.
I know.
Poor auntie.
Oh, I'm just looking at my my stream preview. I have this close-up, extreme close-up of the trance scene from Techno Babylon as my background. I forgot I had done that. God, you gotta ask about everything.
So, I had a grandmother.
Apparently so.
How do you know about her?
It was in your aunt's case history when she was brought to us. Patricia Blackwell's symptoms were the same word.
Have you ever played the Crackwell Legacy?
Patricia's
yes, I have. And the creator of Crackwell is here in the chat, I think. Francisco, are you still there?
Until it struck her daughter.
Do a blowy impression for...
When it struck her daughter, yes.
I'm sorry, I'm going to butcher your name.
Perhaps it's genetic, but...
Amayero? Amayero? Is that how you pronounce it? Did I get it right?
So what should I do?
Right now, nothing.
There's
this
still
type
talking.
Of thing is unprecedented. There is no procedure to go through, no medication I can give you. I just want you to be and
all
come
right.
To
the whole purpose of this is that I want to test it. I know it works. I gotta skip through it. I'm sorry. Yeah. You can pronounce it however you like, dollface. All right.
Is there anything else you need to tell me before?
Right back
I go?
At you.
Your aunt had some personal effects in storage.
Here I am.
As the
I guess, whoops. I guess,
the,
you're
the
beneficiary. Oh, crap. Did it stop? I'm just looking at the, No, it's all good? Okay. The stream is still on. That's weird, because I'm looking at the stream on my desktop, and I see it's not there. But if you guys say it's there, I will believe you. Okay.
It's just a folder, some documents and so on. It's being sent to your address via messenger.
Game wasn't frozen.
Oh,
I was just... the characters just don't move.
No problem at all. Goodbye, Miss Blackwell. My schedule is fairly open now, so I'm always happy to discuss.
Sure.
Game did stop. That's because it's out of focus. Yeah, if I do something like this, if I go to a different window on my desktop like that, the game will stop. But now I'm back, so here we are. All right, so now I think we gotta go back to home. God, that music. Do-do-do-do-do. Something I would do now. What is exactly comes with the update to the newer version of AGS? Mostly, I mentioned this before, but for those of you who came in late, for a cheap stream monitor, try using your phone. That's an interesting idea. All right, there's some questions here, so I'm just going to tackle them one by one. I mentioned this before about the updates, but for those of you who came in late, the major update, the one that I really am interested in, is the 50 people in the stream now, it changes the way it scales up to fit your monitor. Originally, in the older version of AGS, it forces your monitor to shrink down to, it changes the resolution of your monitor to fit the resolution of the game, which is not the way it's done now. It's not the way it should be done. What modern games do is that they scale up your game to fit your monitor. That's the way it should be. AGS didn't do that. And since these games tend to be really, really small, Blackwell Legacy was 320 by, I think, 240. And to force a modern monitor to go that small can screw it up badly. So it caused a lot of weird glitches and weird problems that just got worse and worse the more time went on. And I never updated it because it meant that save games would get corrupted. If you reloaded an old save after you updated it, it would crash and wouldn't work. So I avoided it and put it off for a long time. But it's just got to the point where I'm just like, I gotta update everything. So that's the main thing. That's actually the main thing, the only thing, just more compatibility with modern monitors. That's the main thing. There's other things that would help you when you make a new game, but nothing that's going to help Blackwell specifically. Next question. Gratifying to see that even a developer of a divine caliber like Dave is human. Well, thank you. I think I'm human. Yes. Have you played Firewatch? I haven't. I am familiar with the guys who made it. I've met them a few times at GDC. They're really cool guys. I asked them for advice once in a while on stuff. They're really, really great people. But I have yet to play the game. I will get to it one day. I have a big backlog. Anyway, let's go home. Did she reach out with both hands to open the door? Wait, let me do that again. Nope, just one hand. Okay, my mistake. Oop, there's the letter.
Looks like it's from Bellevue.
You know, my modern designer sensibility would say, she has no need to state the obvious, you should cut that line. That's what I would say to my 2006 self. Speaking of GDC, is there going to be another adventure game meetup? Most likely, yeah, there always is. I don't organize those, but I imagine the guy who usually does will. Have you been to those before? I don't know if Roselle is your real name, so I'm not entirely sure who you are. Very interesting to advert game when you play it with us. It's also interesting to have a sincere, happy discussion. Thank you. I'm honest with myself. That's really all I can be. I'm honest with myself and who I was. I give myself a lot of flack for this game, but I do know that it was all I could have achieved with the experience and the resources I had at the time. So I am okay with that. One thing I planned on doing, which I did do eventually, I think we forgot to do it in Epiphany, was that I wanted this plant to get bigger with every game. And so that's something we did, but didn't quite follow through on. Okay. Oh my god, fuzzy letters. Ah! Look at that. It's so fuzzy. Especially on my big monitor. Wow. Did I really force people to read 25 pages of this? I'm sorry. How I ever lasted 10, 11 years in business. Oh man. I do think these letters are interesting. But oh my god, they are so blurry. But forcing the player to read 25 pages maybe wasn't the best idea. I haven't seen anything. Am I related to Ron Gilbert? No, I am not. I get that a lot, and so does he. Daedalic. I have not played any games by Daedalic. Daedalic published Gemini Rue in Germany. But I never played the German version, so it still stands. Yeah, I know that there is a kind of a glary light behind us, but my wife is working by that light, so I have to position my head, so... you sure? Okay, my wife's being very generous in turning off the light. Okay, are you sure? It does make it very dark. You sure about that?
Is that good for you?
I mean, it's... Turn it back on again? Does anyone mind the light? Turn it back on. Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, 25 is a little much. I admit this now. I thought they were super interesting at the time. I think actually if it was higher resolution, it wouldn't have felt that much. If this was a HD game, because the amount of text on the screen right now would have been able to fit in a much smaller space. So it might not have been so overwhelming, but you know, whatever. Didn't much care. Deponia's awesome. You know, I've heard iffy things about Deponia, but I keep hearing people either love it or they hate it. I haven't played it myself. From what I've seen of the main character, I don't think I would like him, but I should play it, because I should play other adventure games. I'm not going to read all these to you, so I'm just going to skip through them all, blah, 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 blah. Oh my god, there's so many. I'm amazed that Blackwell has as many fans as it does since it started.
There
like
are
this.
Some pictures stuck to the back of this letter.
And then you gotta put them away and look at something else because I'm apparently. Whoa! Here's my cameo.
Hello?
Rosangelina, hi.
Rosangelina, hi.
Bob. Thanks so much for submitting your last review on time. For once.
Yeah.
I've got a little assignment for you today.
Assignment?
Human interest, Blackwell. Suicide. College girl named Joanne Sherman.
That's awful, but...
You know the Brittany house, the NYU dorm?
Yes, but...
Speak to some people on her floor. Get a word in with the roommate.
Listen.
Speak to the RA, too. And hey, see if you can score a picture of the girl.
Okay, I see there's a lot of questions here, so I'm just going to scroll up and answer them.
Versatility. Time to get out of your comfort zone. Jeremy's over at City Hall covering that strike, so you are it.
I still need to play that one. I did go in 2013, but I haven't seen anything since then.
Stupid paper even
who normally organizes them?
I guess it came home. It's not.
My name is
Maybe
Kelsey.
Maybe this isn't a bad... My old note.
Kelsey. Okay. Well, it's nice to meet you again. A guy named Edmundo organizes them. He usually posts about it on Facebook. I'll probably post about it on Twitter as well, so keep that. Keep an eye on that. He's a genetic experiment made from Ron Gilbert and Dave Grossman. Somewhere out there is my lost brother, Ron Grossman. He's out there somewhere. 25 is a little much, yes. German language, any German. It's a German translation, and there's actually German voiceover, and you probably don't know anything about it because it sold like nothing. No one bought it. It was actually really upsetting. No one bought the German version, and it kind of put me off localization because so few people bought it. But maybe I'll get back into it another time. It's just that being a tiny shop like us, we got to really be careful about where we spend our time and money. So let's see. Gemini was interesting in a lot of ways. I didn't care much for the action bits, but the story and atmosphere were fantastic. Thank you. I wish I could take credit for any of that. that was all Josh Nuremberger. He's a brilliant guy. I've met him a few times. He's really, really smart. I wish he'd design more games, but he kind of is doing... he went to seminary school, and he's doing missionary stuff, and he's doing his thing. So I'm not going to force him to design a game. I personally like the letters that come in between a lot of talking, so is the word. Main character seems a bit even bigger jerk than Joey. I don't think Joey's a jerk, really. I really don't. I think in Legacy, he comes across as being more of a jerk. You skipped over the best letter. I skipped over them all. Trying to think of something intelligent to say on chat because I love these games. I'm sure you'll think of something. That is your voice. The credits mention someone else. Oh my god, you're right. Yeah. Originally, it was a different voice actor doing the voice of Rose's boss on the phone. But I edited that sequence down because I felt it went on too long. And since that's the only time you hear the character, I figure I could get away with it. So I cut a lot of the lines down. I cut that sequence down by about half and re-recorded the lines myself because I had no idea how to find the original actor. And I never changed the credits. Oops. Any thoughts on the notebook system all these years later? I think it works. I think that for Blackwell Legacy and Unbound and Convergence, I don't think I quite knew how to use it properly. I figured it out. I figured out the best way to use it. Because I know I'll be talking about that when I get to a point where you use the notebook. But yeah, I still think it works. I don't think I implemented it well in this game. Thanks for these games, Mr. Gilbert. You're very welcome. Anapira, I hope that's how you say your name. Rufus is okay. I have no comment. Hello, Dave. Hello, Acelopole developer. One of my favorite things about Daedalic characters... I have never played a Daedalic game, so I can't comment. Maybe localize the games more for countries where there's less English being taught in school. Again, it's a financial decision. It's like I can't justify the time and cost. And also my own effort, because it's not a matter of just translating a file and you're done. There's a lot of internal coding that needs to be done, which also breaks saves. And also that requires effort and time from myself, and I don't speak the language, so it's even more difficult. So yeah, there's a lot of reasons why I don't do localizations, and again, I feel sorry for it. I felt like we were approaching a twist where Joey was evil, especially near the end. Sorry. Is there a reason Joey comes across that way in this game? The reason is just that I hadn't quite captured his voice yet. That's pretty much it. I was still very new to this game writing thing. I hadn't quite captured his voice, or Rose's for that matter. That's why Rose is still probably very cold and kind of aloof and not very nice in this game. I kind of wanted her to be awkward and standoffish, and I kind of made her do that by being really rude and pushing everyone away, which is a totally valid thing to do, but I don't think it was a a fun character to play, and I own that at this point. Let's see. Adventure games basically run on the back of the field plowed by LucasArts with their default English, German sound season. Getting into new markets would be an uphill battle. Fair enough. If Blackwell ever got a big screen adaption, who would I pick to play Rose and Joey? I don't know. I honestly don't know. I mean, Abe's voice is so cemented as Joey. Same with Rebecca as Rosa, but But Abe doesn't look the part, and neither does Rebecca. Actually, Rebecca kind of looks the part. She's got reddish hair. She's a lot more outspoken and crass than Rosa ever was. I love the notebook, its inventory combination without the ridiculous steps of illogic. Whoops. Thank you. Yeah, I agree. That's why I like the notebook interface myself. Crap. Sorry. I moved to another window. That's why I liked it myself. I originally stole it from Discworld Noir, which is, and I used it in this game. Bunch of free online people, Adventure Games made of those people. Okay, and that's the end of the question, so let's move on. And crap, what am I supposed to do? I have to go to the school and talk to people. Looks like there's a note on the door, doesn't there?
That door leads to my apartment.
Apartment for it. Let's talk to Nishanti. Let's get this conversation out of the way. Maybe being a bit incomplete in the beginning. Yeah, also, I had intended for it to be an episodic series. Oh my god, I love this music.
Hello, Rosa. Come in. Don't mind the pooch. He's harmless.
Come on, boy. Hi, dog.
His name is Moti.
Right. Moti. See ya.
The amount of animations that dog has.
Let me guess, you're hungry again. Go get it.
Had I planned how the mediums were getting insane? Kind of. I knew it was going to be Madeline's fault. Spoilers, sorry. I didn't quite figure out. I had my own idea of how it happened, except that kind of changed and evolved over the course of the series. Because my original idea wasn't very good, and not that it was bad, it was just a little overly complicated and would have required just tons of exposition. So I had an idea, but it kind of evolved and changed. Go get it. That's actually the line I would say to my dog when I gave him a treat. It's, go get it. And she walked through the dog. Make small talk.
So, how are you?
Oh, I'm just fine. Right, Moti? Aren't we just fine?
Oh my god, the woman who plays Nishanti is this, sweet lady named Ruth Weber. She was part of my improv group too. She was a sweetheart. She was so fun. Also lives very far away, otherwise I'd work with her more often. Alright, I know there's a whole bunch of crap I gotta ask her, so
thanks
I'm just gonna go through this.
Thanks again for helping me out earlier. I'd probably be sleeping in a hotel tonight if it weren't for you.
Oh, didn't you hear? The strike's over.
Really?
It only lasted a few hours,
building servants in the strike thing actually happened to me. And I remember being very... didn't happen to me. I mean, yeah, it happened in my building. And I remember thinking that I couldn't leave my ID at home. Or else I'd be stuck and I wouldn't be able to get home. And I kind of took that and put it into this game. It seemed a lot more clever at the time, but like I said, it's kind of a really bad way to start this game.
So, you play the flute?
Yes, I play the flute. It's called a bansuri. What about you? Do you play an instrument?
Me? No, I can hardly play the kazoo.
Yeah, they talk a lot about not very
well,
much
I'm
you.
Trying to be a writer.
I knew it. Anything published?
Nothing really, aside from book reviews in the Village Eye.
Village Eye? You mean that little paper they sell at the stand?
You've read it?
At the stand?
Perhaps I...
Come on, Ruth. The stand?
You have a very nice apartment.
Thank you. A bit small, but that's New York for you.
Yes.
You seem very friendly with the people in this building.
Well, I didn't grow up.
Well, it's not taboo exactly. It's just.
Oh, I know.
I actually lived across the hall in my old building from a really.
Most of the time. You know what I'm talking about?
Not famous exactly, but a really renowned jazz musician. He performed with Miles Davis. He's on Wikipedia. His name is George Coleman. And I didn't know. I never knew until I lived there for like 5 years. And I know he played the saxophone. I would hear him from across the hall. And I never knew he was, like, with Miles Davis. And he was, like, this major, major, like, well-known performer. Because I never talked to him. It's just what you do in New York. And I always... It is a New York thing.
That dog is adorable.
Moti. He's spoiled rotten, but he's good company. He's taken quite a shine to you, that's for...
Huh. Usually I'm not good with animals.
You never had a childhood pet?
A pet? No, I had a teddy bear.
Moti's a little thing, but you wouldn't know it from the amount he
eats. I discovered the hard way that if you don't do all the dialogue, it might glitch and the rest of it just disappears and you get stuck because Joey won't turn her if you don't.
Feel free to
really? Okay, that's interesting. I will have to test that. Thank you.
Why do you play the flute in the park?
It's a place to go, I suppose. I was walking there one day, and I had the bun. Next thing I knew, I had.
That's interesting, because like,
so I go there.
That
as
logic has
as
been
I
in
can.
The game for like 10 years.
Gets me out of this stuffy apartment, and I admit I like the attention.
Happened
plus,
to me when
Moti
both
loves
commentary
the dog
tracks on
there.
At the same time.
Well, he did until they.
So you both had that glitch where Joey won't trigger. Did anyone else have that glitch? Because no one ever told me personally about it, so I'd never fixed it, obviously. So I gotta look into that. Okay, thank you.
Why did they close down the dog run? It seemed okay to me.
Nobody really knows. It started about a week ago. Dogs started howling, running around like maniacs, acting strange. Some even hurled themselves at the fence door trying to get out. They say it's some kind of high-frequency wave, some high-pitched sound.
I'm just gonna zip through this. Oh, feed the dog.
Well, I'd better go.
Take care, Rosa. Come back whenever you'd like.
Dog biscuit. Oh, that's right. You can't actually take your inventory out of the inventory window. That confused everyone.
Go get it.
All right, let's feed the dog.
Here, boy.
The sheer amount of logic that Moti has. We programmed into him.
What do I do now?
Just say, go get it. He'll do the rest.
She's not poisoning him yet. That's later.
See ya.
That's one puzzle I really regret. If I regret any puzzle, it's that one. Because that's such a psychotic thing to do. Adventure
Go
games. At the time, you know, you want to add interactivity where you can, and it's like, let's just stick a puzzle here, and who cares what it is? Let's just do this. I would not do that puzzle now, because it's completely psychotic. My friend is also sick, and you doing this has made her feel better. Oh, you're welcome, Ragna's friend. Or Ragnia? Saying see ya to the dog is pretty good. Brittany Hall, which is literally in the back of my old apartment building. You can see it from my window. No coincidence. Oh, man.
Ugh.
I'm gonna pop one of these.
I feel
little,
like hell, and I just can't be college kids.
How sweet.
Hopefully, this won't take too long.
Dude, this is my favorite piece of music in this game, and I actually reused it in Blackwell Epiphany. If you found the famous Easter egg room, I used this music. I know a lot of non-American testers didn't know what an RA was. And that confused them.
Hi, I'm Rosangela Blackwell.
Can I help you?
Perhaps.
Oh my God.
Could I ask you a few questions?
The actor who plays this guy.
This is about Joanne, isn't it?
You know her?
Well,
his name is Thomas
RA
Tucker.
I wouldn't be doing my job.
He was a very good friend of mine once upon a time.
The campus police found her around 5 a.m. this morning.
Can you tell me about her?
Well, alright. But could you leave my name out of it?
He was an interesting guy, Thomas, because he did a lot of radio, so he knew exactly how to breathe, and that was actually the first time I'd ever seen someone really work a microphone and do it the right way.
That shouldn't be a problem.
Good. Joanne's parents have already asked the dean to fire me.
I don't know, Rosella. I know some testers had trouble learning what it was. Ooh. That tooltip is pretty slick. I don't think I put that in the later games. Why didn't I put that in later games? That's really cool. Why did I not do that again? Okay.
Could you tell me about Joanne again?
Well, as I said, I didn't know her socially, but she seemed nice enough. Nobody ever complained about her. She always had friends around her. She never had any trouble, as far as I know. Her suicide came as a total surprise.
Would you have a picture of Joanne?
A picture? No. Why would I?
Just asking. Can you tell me anything about Joanne?
She jumped off the roof. She died instantly. It was in the middle of the night.
God, he looks like a baby.
There was no
way
anybody
could have
stopped her. Make sure you print that.
So how did you get to be an RA of this floor?
What do you mean?
Well, it's a girl's floor, and you, well...
aren't?
Yes.
Well, it's like this. Someone at the registrar thought Adrian was a girl's name. So here I am.
None of the girls have complained?
Not yet. This sort of thing happens quite frequently. You'd be surprised.
God, I remember thinking
well,
that whole...
Well, that's all for now. Thanks for help.
Just remember...
that whole name thing was so clever.
Just a bunch of notices. Guitar lessons, study groups, stuff like that.
I don't know why I felt like I had to have a whole big scrolling room here.
The sign reads, Amanda Fay and Karen Schreier.
Oh, that's it. So I could reference random friends
the
of mine.
The sign says... Ew, there's gum stuck to the faucet. I'm not touching that. The sign says, Shelley Chenoy and Sarah Elmale.
Two of my regular voice actresses.
Yeah?
Oh my god. Woman playing Kelly, her name is Chen Young, who I haven't spoken to like since Blackwell Legacy. I have no idea what happened to her. She was really fun to work with.
Hi, I'm Rosangela Blackwell. With the Village Eye?
The Village what?
You're right, Rosella.
The Village
That would have happened.
The newspaper.
I've never heard of it.
Never heard of it. Actually, it was this character that put me off doing accents for any character ever, because they just never turn out well. She's actually a very, very good actress, but it does not come across here, because this accent just didn't turn out nice.
It's just a small paper.
Yeah, I guess that. What do you want?
I'd like to talk to you about your roommate, if that's all right.
Jesus Christ. I'm busy with midterms. I told the campus police everything. Do you have to bother me?
She's
Look,
very breathy.
So she killed herself. Big whoop. Why is that my problem?
Back in the day, I never bothered editing, like, things like breath pops out of voiceover. So some actors are worse at breath pops than others. And this character is one of those. Actually, the worst one is the deacon at the end of the game.
I understand that this must be a difficult time for you.
Difficult? Hell no. It's been great. You know how long I've been wanting my own room?
That's funny, Mr. Joe. I actually kind of thought the same thing, that she reminded me of Kelly. But I held back from... because I did the voice acting for that game. I don't know if you know that. I directed the voice acting for that. And I did not give Kathy Rain a Bronx accent, or Brooklyn accent, rather.
It must have been hard, living with someone you don't like.
What? You're psychoanalyzing me now?
Psychoanalyzing me now?
What the hell do you know about it? You're really starting to piss me off.
Wow. Edgy, ma'am. Look at that skull tank top.
Never mind. Forget it.
Yeah, right.
I don't want to burn. We're not there yet.
Look, my boss will kill me if I come back with nothing. Can't you help me out here?
I think I might have set this music volume
Joanne?
A little
she
too
said.
Loud for this.
She
scene.
Couldn't take the pressure, so she jumped off the roof.
Did Joanne act unusual before she died?
Nope. Quiet as a.
So Joanne was a good student.
Yeah, sure. What?
Joanne never had trouble sleeping.
How would I know?
You
How
lived
would
with
I
her.
Know?
Like I pay attention.
That kind of outfit was very typical for college students in the early 2000s, late 90s. Like the pajama pants. which the pajama trousers, which looked like trousers, but they were pajamas.
Is there anything else you can tell me about Joanne?
No.
No?
Yeah, sure, whatever.
Do you have a photograph of Joanne that we could use for the newspaper?
You want a what?
Just a photograph. You'll get it right back.
Yeah, right. You think I'm giving you anything? Think again.
Wow, she got really, really tight there. That's something I would direct now.
Can you tell me anything about Adrian?
The RA? He's okay. He helps us out when we need it and keeps us the way it should be.
Can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Why do you want to know?
Just background info for the paper.
Oh.
I don't know if pajama pants are still in style. I'm 40. I don't know what's in style.
Thanks for helping out.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Though I've never known what's in style. You guys probably... This will probably be a surprise to all of you. But I've never been terribly cool. Uh-oh. Oh, the stream is up? Wait, it says it's streaming. It says it's working. Okay. You have games to make. Stay away from the... I'm not ready to move on yet. Gosh. Okay, wait, so is it? Did it stop for everybody or just for... I'm sorry, I get your name.
Hi, it's me again.
Amayero.
Yeah.
Is
that okay?
Frozen for anybody else?
What do you want to know?
Okay, stream is still going for Rosella. Okay, well, if it's going for Rosella, then that's all we need. Okay. Missed most of the last 10 minutes. I'm sorry, Parker. Steam is still going strong for Mandy. Fine for Kevin. Fine for Rosella. Fine for Jell. Fine for Corrupt Biggins. That's a great name. All right. Seems to be fine. All right, yay. All right, so now we got to ask him about
Kelly.
What
can you tell me about Joanne's...
Kelly? Have you met her?
Yes.
Quite a sight, huh? But... Don't judge her by that. She's the sharpest kid you'll ever meet. She
I guess
gets straight
it's
A's on
really.
Yep.
Goes to show what kind of person I was that I thought that like the fact that giving Kelly like this tough accent and piercings was edgy. Yeah. I wish I could say I was young, but I wasn't. Wait.
Well, that's all. Thanks for...
Just remember...
Hi, it's...
You have more questions, I imagine?
Yeah, is that...
What do you...
Alright, Joanne slept all day, Joanne studied all night. Studied all day, slept all night.
Was Joanne a good student?
I don't think she had any problems, but of course, the pressure can get to anyone.
Whoa, what happened to the sound there?
Do you know if Joanne had any trouble sleeping?
I'm afraid I wouldn't. Her roommate, Kelly, never complained, but that's not surprising.
Why is that?
Well, Kelly rarely spent the night in her room. She only comes here to study, as far as I've seen.
Kelly sleeps elsewhere. Okay.
Well, that's all for now. Thanks for helping out.
Just remember, leave my name out of it.
Slam! All right. Now to combine notes. Kelly sleeps elsewhere. Joanne slept all night.
Wait a minute. Something isn't right. If Kelly's been spending her night somewhere else, how can she know if her roommate was sleeping well or not?
I wish Notebook could have been on screen at the same time. You needed to type some research from it. I don't think that was an issue in this game, because you never did have to type in research. Later games you could, not this one. Alright, I seem to be losing people in the channel because the buffering, it seems to be buffering for people. Did Kelly lie?
Your RA told me that you haven't been sleeping in your dorm.
Yes, so?
You told me that Joanne slept in your room every night.
So?
Yes, so?
How would you know Joanne slept here if you've been sleeping somewhere else?
Huh? Oh, well, I just assumed.
Did you lie to me?
I didn't lie. I just... Oh, screw it. You want to talk? Fine. What do you want to know?
What bitrate am I streaming at? I don't know how to determine that. Unless that question is directed to other people, not me. How do I determine what rate I am streaming? I'm very new at this. Okay, let's see. I'm at 30 FPS. Is that what you mean? Let's see. I'm just checking here. Encoding. Maximum bitrate is 3300. That's what I'm at. Encoder is X264. Bitrate is 128. Let's see. Oh, okay. Yeah. My kilobits per second. About 3400. So I guess that's not a lot. Okay, not a. I'm just gonna keep going then. Sorry, guys.
I could really use a photo of Joanne, if you have one.
All right, just a sec. This was hers. It was on her desk. She won't be needing it anymore. Joanne's the girl on the left.
Thanks. Thanks for helping out.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Whatever. I love this. I love this picture. I do love these pictures from all the Blackwell games. Girl, Joanne.
According to Kelly, this girl on the left is Joanne. I assume that this is a friend of Joanne, but I have no idea who she is.
Okay, I will take your word for it, Rosella. I don't know much about this. All right, here we go.
Ugh. This is getting worse. At least I have enough for the story now. I'd better get home.
There was supposed to be like a musical sting when she goes like this, like a little and I guess it didn't play for some reason. Unless I removed it, because it was a pretty annoying sound. I should turn the commentary on.
This is getting bad.
Well, I gotta test the commentary, so I'll just quickly turn it on and see what happens.
Hello, this is Dave Gilbert.
There I am.
Welcome to the commentary track for the Blackwell Legacy.
I'll just skip that.
Hi, this is Dave Gilbert. You have activated the 5 years later.
5 years later commentary track. And now it's 6 years after that. Oh my god. Stop moving so fast, time. Alright, let's X out of that.
Oh my god, this really hurts. Sleep, that's all I need. I'll just type up the story and get to bed. Shouldn't take that long.
I'm gonna make a note of that. Headache, sound effect, not playing. I'm wondering if that's the case with all sound effects, because I don't know if... Have all sound effects been playing? Did the door sounds open? Yes, okay, that plays. So, I know that's not the issue. But... There's music... Let's see if it plays now that there's music. Okay, it plays. Doing QA live. Well, yeah, this is what happens when you upgrade to a new version of the engine. You get all sorts of strange bugs that were not there before. Usually they have to do with sound almost every single time. Okay, what am I doing? Oh yeah, writing up my article. Write your article.
Right. No more interruptions.
Right, indeed. Go write. Right, Rosa.
Done. Article's finished.
There's the sting. Okay, so it's not gone completely.
No.
What I really hoping was live AGS editing. You know, I think I might do that too. I thought of doing a like a developer
what
stream of
happening?
Unavowed at some point. Except right now I'm just kind of doing really boring stuff.
It's gone. The pain.
But I think
it's
I
gone.
Will do that, Rosella. It's something
it
I've been
strange.
Meaning to do forever.
It was like
Oop.
What? is that?
Photoshop highlight.
The photo. Something is different about it.
Rosa stayed in the obvious over and over again.
No, no, no. I did not just see that. I am not going crazy. No, it's just the stress, that's all.
I'm gonna sneeze. Forgive me right now.
Death, work, life. I just need a rest. That's all.
I'm sneezing over Joey.
Why do they always do that? So, Griff, long time no see. How's Trix?
Vaguely remember there being a nighttime version of this.
Thought as much.
Or with the lights off.
Blackwell dames.
But
always
you could barely see Joey.
You're always sleeping.
With the lights off,
I'm
so I left
watching.
Them on.
Yep, that's me. The eternal chump.
The eternal
it's about chip. Time. Hey, nap time, Nelly. Wake up.
What?
Shall we try this again?
No.
Now that's not very polite.
Go away.
It
I'm
lives
afraid
again.
I can't
Great.
Do that, darling. Believe me, I've tried.
No, you don't exist.
All right, so this is like
yes,
the
do.
Beginning of a long series
Look,
of cutscenes. So
not happening. This is not happening.
This is a good time to like
oh,
ask questions in the feed, if you like.
I'm not going insane. There is nothing.
There's
there.
Almost a commercial
should
break.
You? No.
What I should have done was added that in the original
friend,
freeware,
not going to end up
Bestowers
like
of
that.
Eternity, that's
Listen.
The moment where I said to be
Get
continued,
out of my head.
And everyone hated
There's
me.
There's nothing there. There's nothing there. There's nothing there.
Could you?
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up.
No.
Just in time for
you
the
shut up.
Bay?
You're going to listen. And you're going to listen good. I've been watching you all day, sweetheart. You know who I am.
No.
Yes. I'm not going away, so there'd be no point in beating around
you know,
the bush.
You know, if I was
say my name.
Gonna do this
no.
all over again.
Damn you, you know my name, now say it.
You're,
oh my
yes.
God.
You're Joey?
It shows how innocent I was back then that I saw nothing problematic with any of these lines.
And look at
I.
Don't worry.
Oh dear.
I won't bite. Couldn't even if I wanted to. Hi there.
Accepting response.
You really exist?
Oh, yes. Live and in person. Although I'm not really alive, and I'm not sure if I can still call myself a person anymore.
So who are you?
How am I doing today?
I'm alone.
And I'm better than I have been for like a week. I completely
what?
Missed New
Maybe
Year's Eve because I was,
legacy, darling.
I was really sick.
From one generation to the next.
But I'm much
like
better now.
Heirloom.
Thank you.
First your grandmother got
something a little
me,
suggestive. It gets worse.
And now you.
It gets much worse. Yeah, I'm aware of that. And I don't know why I didn't think of it at the time that it was really, really suggestive. And it's not like I was young and innocent. I was 30 years old when I wrote this game. You think I would have known better, but nope.
So you're a ghost.
Yep.
You're a ghost. There's a ghost in my apartment.
Hey, you're sharp. It took your aunt and grandmother ages to work that out.
Why have you been haunting my family?
Haunting? Is that what I'm doing? Mm-hmm. That's a real ugly word.
Answer me. Why are you here?
You got me,
Joey
sweetheart.
Joey is kind of a jerk
I've
in this game, isn't he?
Why me and why your family?
Would I ever make a modern style adventure game?
Must be some kind of gift your family has.
I don't know. Like, it's funny you say
you're
modern style. I often
a
think our style is quite modern,
with the
at least in terms of design and gameplay.
Dear, have
in terms
of
graphics,
of
I mean.
That connection.
I don't.
If someone gave me the
I
money,
understand any of this.
Oh, you will, babe. You will.
Even if someone did give me the money,
while,
it also would be the expertise
really
involved
That's
in getting that done
why,
is a little
why what?
Out of my wheelhouse at the moment.
Well.
I'd have to hire
but that's
really good people
later.
To help
you
me
felt
with that.
Something today, didn't you?
But
felt something?
Yeah, you felt
especially if you do like something in 3D. I don't know anything about how 3D works or how to design for it. Washington Square Park.
You mean
if I need a cheap 3D guy?
Yeah, that's where we've got to go.
What, right now?
Yep, it would be really cheap.
But it's the middle of the night.
It's really
so
sad
you've
to
just
say.
Had a nice nap. You should be ready for action.
I'm not going out to Washington Square
Park. Probably
in the middle of
guessed
the night.
We don't
no,
have a lot of
that's
money
where
to
you're
work
wrong.
With.
If there's any reason behind
have
this,
have I played any of the Phoenix Online Studios 3D
like
adventure games?
We have to take care of them.
By the way, I mean,
soon.
Is this annoying them? Me talking over them? If that's annoying, I'll lower their volume. Have I played the Phoenix Online stuff? Yes, I have. I've played a bit of Cognition. I'm sad to say I never finished it. I haven't finished the first game. I got up to a certain point and I stopped, and I didn't pick it back up again. And I always meant to. I just never did. But yeah, I know Katie really well. I hang out with her a lot at game dev events. I think that Mobius definitely had issues. I haven't played that either. But yeah, no, I like what they do. I think they do... wait, what? No, talk, please. It's interesting. I'm not saying I'll stop talking. I'm saying should I lower their volume? If they're if me
this
talking
over
here
much.
Like now, if I'm
I've
talking over them and if it's
sorry,
all confusing
kiddo,
and stuff
go
and a little chaotic, I can turn their volume down. The audio balance is good. Okay,
like
that's good. That's good. That's good. Audie
was
is
that
fine.
Because of you? Did you do
my
that?
My day job
not
keeps
me
kid, comfy.
Me.
I do it for the
I
love of it.
I didn't make him that way, and I don't know what did. But do you really want to sit around
adventure
here
games
and find
look
out?
Weird in 3D. Hard to look as good as 2D. It depends. It depends on the game. If you do it really well, then it's timeless. I mean, if you look at something like The Journey Down, which I also haven't played, I think that's beautiful. Journey Down is gorgeous. But it's a very specific art style that lends itself well to 3D. Those you know, African masks. Wow, my throat is... my voice is kind of going here.
I can't believe this is happening.
I can't believe this is
believe
happening.
It.
Played a bit of Cognition too. My problem with Cognition was I say this not in a bad way because I'm guilty of the same thing in Blackwell, is that I found the main character to be not very likable, but I hear that it gets better later, and the same feedback could be leveled at Rosa Blackwell in Blackwell Legacy. I don't think Rosa is very likable in this game. I think she's interesting, just not likable. And I made her... She gets more likable and more interesting later on, but apparently... what's her name? Reed? Oh my god. Erica Reed in Cognition gets more likable and more interesting as the series goes on. So I need to give it another try. I have it in my Steam library. I have yet to click play.
Maybe I am going crazy. Maybe I'd prefer going crazy.
Sorry, Sugar, you're totally sane. Deal with it.
I'm a
fine.
Big fan of snarky redheads, so there
that's
we go.
That's the spirit.
I guess, hence being friends with Katie.
After you.
Is Katie Hallinan a redhead?
That was strange. Everybody just ignored you. Am I the only one who can see you?
Yep, and hear me. So keep your voice low. Oh, yeah. This is the spot. Can you see it?
I don't see
anything.
This
is like a
go?
Long, like, 20-minute cutscene where
hey,
there's
wait.
No interactivity, and I really hate myself for designing this. I warned you I'd be very hard on myself when playing my own game.
It goes against
game.
The rules, whatever they are. Now, look inside there.
Love the way he delivered that
look
line.
Look close.
It goes against the rules, whatever they are.
What am I supposed to see?
Just wait. It'll come.
Wait, I see something. Who is that?
That's what we're here to find out. I'll talk to the spook. You can stay here.
Okay.
I'll talk to the spook.
Now watch and learn. Why so down, beautiful? Ah. I'm a bit out of practice. How should I handle this?
God. Playing this now is just... Joey just comes off so much as a creeper. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being very judgmental, or maybe just the kind of... what's the word? I guess the environment has changed over the last several years when it comes to this kind of stuff, that suddenly I'm finding him a lot more creepy than he used to be. I don't know. Let's be charming.
Hey, don't be like that. If there's one thing I hate, it's seeing a pretty
Joey got a lot of practice when he was alive, I imagine. Been watching Technocrat Games work with Unity in the tweets he puts out. It's really interesting. Yeah, he's learned a lot about Unity. I'm really impressed by, oh my god, that's a loud crashing sound. Yeah, James Dearden's kind of brilliant.
Leaving so soon?
But he's our jerk. Yes, he is.
They all run. Oh. So hard to hold on.
Now, this character is also played by Chen Young, who played Kelly in the dorm room. So she actually is a very good actress and has a very nice voice. It's just that character of Kelly does not sell her talents well. But this character really does. I think she did a really good job with this ghost.
Shh. Relax. Slow down.
It's cute that it
everything.
Doesn't matter much.
I'm here to help.
I guess charm
help.
Goes a long way.
Help. He wants me to help him. But I want to help them. Don't they know that?
Help who?
Can't. They run away.
We won't run away.
No.
How many people are in the channel? 20. I've lost like 30 people.
No, we're sick. He poisoned us. Got into our head and poisoned us.
Whatever happened, darling, it's over.
That's a good point, Rosella.
You do know that, don't you?
No.
That was my justification, too.
Stay away or I'll poison you.
That he was from a different time.
Run away like all the others.
Yeah, keep talking like that, sister, and you'll be doing the running. Now, why don't you shut your yap and calm the hell down?
Wow. All right, that was harsh.
It's you.
Who?
You're him!
Now, look, darling, sweetheart.
Baby
Leave
doll.
Me.
Hey.
Leave.
I think Joey originally said baby doll there, too, but I cut that because it sounded creepy.
Look, just sit tight. We'll figure this out. And we'll be back.
Praise Gilbert. Well.
Friggin' ghosts. Can't get a straightforward answer out of any of them.
What just happened?
What just happened is we've got an unstable spirit on our hands. Haunting that dog park over there. You wondered why the mutts don't like it here? That's the reason.
There's a ghost haunting the dog park.
That's what I said.
A ghost.
Sure.
What am I doing?
I told-
No. No, I really should go to bed.
Hey, wait a sec.
Yeah, sleep. I shouldn't be here.
Oh, for the love of Pete.
He never said for the love of Pete again. And now we come to another lengthy, unplayable cutscene. I'm really sorry about this.
What an odd...
You never go into Rose's
bedroom.
Good
morning, Bright Eyes.
Not in five games.
You're still here.
Wouldn't be anywhere else.
For the love of Gressor.
Has anybody told you to
Deny it, throw it in his face.
If it bothers you so much, you can always leave.
I wish I could, dear. I told you, I couldn't leave even if I wanted to.
So this is going to be my life from now on?
Pretty much, yeah.
You're going to follow me around for the rest of my life.
That's how it works, as far as I can tell.
Great. Just great.
Hey, it ain't all a bed of roses for me either, dollface. You think I chose to be shackled to your family for the last 40 years? Your grandmother refused to accept it, and look what happened to her.
And Auntie?
She made a mistake.
What kind of mistake?
Hey, what is this, 20 questions? What's with the third degree?
Are you hiding something?
Who, me? I'm an open book. It's not my fault you can't read.
What does that mean?
I do like that line.
It means zip it.
Look, this isn't easy, you know. You're a ghost? Fine. I'm a medium? Fine. My whole life is turned upside down? Fine. But you could at least meet me halfway.
You've accepted it, you say?
So far, yes.
You've only seen a taste of it. Are you ready to go all the way?
I don't know.
What
Maybe
do you mean?
Any Blackwell drinking games. I am sure...
What this is all about.
You could make one. Positive, incredulous, or bitter. Oh my god. I'm incredulous that I actually did this.
Yes.
Good. Maybe there's hope after all.
So what is it?
I don't have to tell you. It's best if I show you.
Here, yeah, this is the suggestive bit that I did not even consider.
The only part of me you can touch.
Oh, God.
Unfortunately.
That's painful.
It kind of tingles.
What is God, it? Dave.
The stuff of life. Or death. I've never quite worked it out.
What now?
Now you pull.
Pull the tie?
Yeah, pull.
Okay. Oh my God, where have you taken me?
Relax. Take your time. It's a lot to take in at once.
What is this place?
It's the doorway to infinity, darling. Out there, in the distance, the next world. The next plane of existence. The gossamer threads that separate this.
This is literally a 20-minute cutscene with no interactivity. Well, there's some dialogue choices and stuff, but
how did we get here?
We're inside your head.
You mean I'm dreaming?
No, I mean we're literally inside your head. Remember those headaches you had yesterday?
Yeah.
That was your power awakening. Or to be more specific, it
node
was this
space.
Place.
It's funny. Okay, you call it node space. Oh my God, this music's awesome. You call it node space, but I never actually called it node space in the game. But yet, somehow people actually know it as being node space. So could I ask you, how did you know it was called node space? Yeah, there is a lot of bass in this track. It's funny how the first game has this like electronica kind of style, where none of the rest of the games, which are composed by Thomas Reagan. Oh my God, soundtrack title, really? Okay, I didn't even think of that. Duh. Okay, Dave. Inquire about your head. Oh my
There's
God.
There's a hole in my head.
Sort of.
I'm not sure I like this. Well, like it or not, so what does this place actually do? It serves a transfer point or node. It connects the mortal world with the next. Commentary. I must have mentioned it in the commentary. I call it the void now. Later on in the series, I call it the void. A bit more to it than that. I thought as much. You see, many ghosts aren't as lucid as myself. Most can barely.
You dig, you don't dig. Okay, that's awesome.
I think so. The ghosts don't know they're dead.
Yeah, yeah, right. So, we have to help them accept it. Once they accept their death, they are much more willing to move on. That's my job, see? Anyway, I know you have some questions about that.
All right, let's just get out of here.
I think
I... Yes, I'm sure.
Let's go.
Called it the void because I learned it was node space. Yeah. The void makes more sense.
Welcome back.
Ugh.
Take it easy. It's a little disorientating.
I'm fine. So what now? Go back to the park and bring her to that place?
You got it.
And how do we do that?
There are three steps. First, we have to find out more about her. Second, we use that information to get through to her, convince her that she's dead. And three, help her move on.
He don't have a shovel. Da, da, da. This is the one bit of Peter Gresser's music that actually stuck around. This became Rosa Blackwell's theme that was used a lot. I love Abe. It was a nice surprise to hear him in the Charnel House trilogy. He actually recorded, Abe actually recorded those lines in my apartment. So I was there directing him, or reading the other person's lines. I quite like Charnel House. Step one, steal underpants. Two, profit. Disorientating? I think he might have, yeah. Ask about
how do we help a ghost move on?
With my magic tie, dear. I give one end to the spook, the other end to you. You pull the ghost in.
You don't.
Alright, I'm gonna just go through all of these dialogues. Oh my God, they talk so much. Okay, now I can play again. Hey, it's quite a good plot. I love the Rosa apartment theme and how it evolves. Me too. It just sort of changes with every game. I'm gonna save here.
Larg.
And now I gotta...
I wanna talk to you, Joey.
Yeah?
Ask about Joey. Ask about ghostly towers. Yeah. Here's the thing that everyone always gets stuck on, because they don't do
neat
this.
Trick, huh?
Not
they don't.
Everyone.
They don't do that, and then they can't solve a puzzle later. And then they, Abe is in Pokemon. Isn't that cool? Yeah, Abe is in Pokemon. I don't know who he plays because I don't watch Pokemon, but yeah, I'm really happy, really happy to see Abe doing more voiceover because he is so good. Not just a good actor, but he has like amazing instincts. Like it's something that you have or you don't, where you just can get it on the first or second take with very little direction. Thanks, Lady Byron. I really, I like that too. It helped that I decided to show Rose's apartment from a different angle, and I was trying to think of what would go on that wall. You know, the wall that's kind of down here behind the couch, and I just decided to make it mementos from all the previous games, including Unbound.
You coming?
Yeah, sure.
A Blackwell AU? What's a Blackwell AU? Sorry, I'm not with it, with the terminology. Do 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 do. Okay. Now what to do, what to do. Let's go to the Britain house. Alternate universe? Basically just filled her apartment with stuff of dead people. Yeah, she kind of did. Well, they weren't using it.
It's open.
After you.
Yeah?
Whoa. Oh my god. Heavy, holy contrast, Batman. That is a... Wow, that is an ugly looking room. Okay, I should be selling this game more. I mean, gosh. No, this is... Again, I had very little budget and experience and resources at the time. This is what I came up with. It's just a lot of bright, busy colors against very plain walls. And no texture on these walls at all, which even me, with my severe lack of art talent, would not do. All right, let's talk to Kelly.
Could I ask you some follow-up questions, Kelly?
Fine. Make it quick.
I'm that annoying person who always... Wait, what? I just... was always writing the fanfics and tweeting them at you. Oh, Corner and Chair? Is that you? There was something significant about that doll. You mean this doll? Yes, actually, that is actually what Rosa looked like in my original freeware Bestowers of Eternity. She had that like pink outfit. She had the red hair and no glasses. So, two girls, one bed. I think the beds are like down here and over here. that's what I say.
Thanks again.
Whatever.
Well, good to kind of virtually meet you.
I'm not lugging that thing around.
Well, let's look at it then, huh? The future, Mrs. Davenport.
The future, Mrs. Davenport? I wonder what that means. I recognize her. That's Joanne. That's her. The ghost in the park. She looks so happy here. I wonder what happened to make her like that.
Oh, did I say table and chair? I meant corner and chair, sorry. All right. You know... Alright, it's notebook and telephone.
It's just a telephone. Can I?
No. Joanne and I, but I'll be dead.
No. Alright, let's
Could I ask you some follow-up?
Fine, make it quick.
Could you tell me about the other two girls in the photo? Them. You know them. Only Joanne. Do you know their names?
Blonde girl is Allie.
She even thanked Rosa for... Oh yeah, in an email. I really was happy with that. I'm proud of how that turned out. When I enabled Rosa to get emails, I had to add that. Because the job is often so thankless that I had to add at least one of those.
They didn't care for me, and I didn't much care for them.
Basically, I was Kelly in college. I wasn't like as edgy or as determined as her, but my roommate was the social butterfly and invited everyone in, and I hated it. Oh, it drove me crazy.
Do you know anything about Joanne's friend Allie?
You mean Miss Blondie?
Yeah.
I know enough, which isn't much. She was over here all the time visiting Joanne.
All the time.
She was kind of sweet, I guess.
Laughed all the time.
That was annoying. That was usually my cue to get out of here. What do you want to know about her?
I'm having difficulty finding her. Would you know where she is?
I don't know. She could be anywhere. Studying, partying.
Pushing up daisies.
Shh. Huh?
Nothing.
Right.
Not everyone hates her. Need some water.
Thanks for helping out.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Whatever.
Thanks again, Kelly.
Whatever.
Whatever. Yeah.
Can I use your phone?
What?
It'll only take a second.
Fine, fine. Just hurry up.
In later games, she has a cell phone.
Who do you think you're calling?
This puzzle confused everyone, because it sounded like, you know, no dialogue option, whatever. Yeah, no, you talked to... Whoops.
Thanks again, Kelly.
Yeah,
can I use your... It'll only...
Yeah.
Hello, could I speak to Joey, please? Hi, Joey? Yes, I had some questions for you.
Not bad. If you got something to say, say it quick. Lady Pincushion here is starting to look a little hot under the collar.
Oh, God, these dialogue options are so vague.
You performed a little trick for me earlier. I'd like you to repeat it for me.
Trick?
Joey, do you see the pile of papers on the desk?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Can you work your magic on them?
I was very tempted when I...
Sure, I can handle that.
I don't want to say remastered,
again,
but when
Kelly.
I redid the game in 2011 to enable control of Joey, simply so you could do this puzzle with Joey. But, it was only so far I really wanted to go with it.
Hello? Hop.
Request.
Joey, could you...
I'm not...
Thanks again, Kevin.
Yeah.
Nice one.
Bye, Kelly.
So, congratulations, kid.
I missed it?
You
I did, yeah.
Your first burglary.
Because I was talking to you guys.
For the greater good, kid. For the greater good.
That makes me feel so much better.
Alright, let's see here. Notebook.
Looks like standard. It looked a lot. I'd...
Doodle. I once found this exact same sketch, like on someone's, I don't know where, like on the hallway or I don't know. Of my old, when I was in college, I found this. And I always thought it was neat because it told me so much about these people. Without even knowing them, so I thought that was cool. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Yeah, if whatever, yeah. My wife needs to get my daughter soon. Alright, so let's... What's the name that's crossed out? Let's see. Actually, I don't even know, let's see. Joanne and... I think it's implying that it's been a long time since I made this game. Like, I think 11 years. It's implying that Joanne had recently broke up with someone, I guess. It's not made relevant in the game. It's just a neat little background detail, I guess. Alright, so... Oh, right, wait.
Man, I hate this place. I was stuck here for 25 years. Why'd you have to drag me back here, huh?
Right, I think... Adrian Alexander?
The school thought that Adrian was a girl because of his name. Alex could also be a girl's name. I wonder. I think it's safe to say that these refer to the same person.
Dun, dun, dun. Wow, this game is taking a lot longer to play than I thought. I thought this game would be like an hour. I thought this would take an hour. Let's see. Oh wait, I can use the computer to do research. I forgot about that. Whoops, sorry. Da-da. Yeah, Biggins, you're right about cross-referencing the notes. That was the biggest problem with the notebook interface, that people just forgot to do it. They just forgot to that they could do it. It was really, it was strange how, I guess because it wasn't used often enough, that people would just forget about it. And it was very flawed in that way. Do research.
And Alexander Davenport was listed as being on the hockey team at NYU. It doesn't say anything else about him, though.
Susan.
Without a last name, the word Susan is pretty useless. It's too common a name.
Okay, yeah, now I remember what to do. It's been so long since I played this, I gotta talk to the ghost of the park. Spoiler things, Rosa. Oh, yeah.
Sure.
Dave Gilbert just forgot about the most Dave Gilbert part of games? What would that be? Spoiler things that Rosa is supposed to know. I love doing that.
Please note.
Okay, how do I dog walk entrance? Here we go.
I don't want to, but I guess we should talk to the ghost again.
Don't worry.
Yeah, that's...
Hey there.
No. Maybe.
I think I mentioned in the commentary. Oh, I'm sorry, Mindy. But she can't actually... I'm just going to quickly type. Sorry, sad face. This it was this background and the way the characters are in front of it that made me decide not to ever set a Blackwell game in daytime because they don't come out very nice. Get right to the questions. Oh, the Googling. Yeah, you're right. Alright.
Can you tell me about your friend Susan?
Quiet Sue. Little Lady Lee.
Lady Lee.
Always
okay.
Meeting, always there. Once.
Lady.
Sending away all my friends.
Deacon. Though... Okay, good.
Can you tell me who the Deacon is?
The Deacon? We called. He got it. He's. No.
I'm skipping a lot of this. I'm sorry, because I've been at the stream for a very long time. I think I need to speak to Allie.
Is your name Allie?
Yes, that's me. Alan
Montego,
she kisses a boy.
Cute, well.
Okay, let's see.
Are you friends with a girl named Joanne?
Joanne? Beware of Joanne.
Okay, here we go.
Look, just, we'll figure this out, and we'll be back.
Why does Ali have couplets for all her friends? I don't know, I thought it was...
What?
You know.
It was a kind of a cute, disturbing thing I thought would be a neat thing to do. I always envisioned the Allie character or the Allie friend as being kind of like the happy, flighty one, and she seemed the type to like do that as a ghost because you're a little confused and out of it. So that's what I did. It's sort of a cheat, the fact that ghosts are confused and deny that they're dead and they will refuse to say arbitrary things, and it actually made designing stuff a little easier because I could deliberately obstruct information from you when talking to a ghost, things like their name or like where they live or very obvious things, but because they're ghosts and a little out of it, they might not want to tell you or they might say the wrong thing. So I was able to get away with a lot that way.
Lee is a pretty common name, but it should narrow things down. I think I got her. Susan Lee, 18 years old, was admitted to Bellevue Hospital last week after an apparent suicide attempt.
I think that's our girl.
Yep.
That's too common a word. Whoever the Deacon is, I don't think I'll find him this way. Allie Montego. Let's see if I can find her. She apparently spent some time
on
the spiritual internet.
But I could still see you
looking for information about
in the chat.
Ouija boards? Are Ouija boards Dickens?
Oh, a few of those things.
Alright, let's see here. Alright, so Susan Lee is at Bellevue. Let's go to Bellevue. Do 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 do.
You coming?
Yeah, sure.
It's funny how the game waits for Joey to leave the room before moving to the next room. I wouldn't do that now. I would like just show that he moves like for a fraction of a second to imply that he's moving out of the room, and then cut to the next room. It's kind of a film television trick.
Is Susan Lee a patient here?
Susan? Yeah, we've got her. She came in about a week ago.
May I visit Susan Lee?
Sure. Sorry, she'll be out in a week.
Whoops.
I'd like to see Susan Lee, please.
I told you, you're not on the guest list.
Oh, well, that's because... You didn't see it? Maybe you should check again.
I missed it, huh?
I'm sure of it. Smile.
Well, let's check again. What was your name again?
Alex.
My name is Alex Davenport.
Huh. Your name is on the list.
Can I go in now?
Sure. I'll notify...
Thanks.
Making your dog's paws dance to the background music.
No, I'm sorry.
Where's Alexander?
Oh, gosh. Susan's played by a woman named Jenna Staris, who just moved back to New York. And she's got a kid about my age. She has a kid that's my kid's age. And we've been meaning to hang out forever, and we just haven't.
We should,
yeah. All right. Fend confusion now. Tell the truth.
He's not here.
They told me he was coming.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but I...
It's okay. He doesn't want to see me anyway. Who are you?
My name is Rosangela. I'd like to talk to you if that's okay.
Are you a doctor?
There's still no Epiphany soundtrack. Oh god, I know. There's so many things I've been meaning to do, like get the Blackwell... Actually, a lot of our game soundtracks up on Steam are available anywhere. All I can say is that we're a small shop. Little things like that tend to slip us by. Things like, you know, updating these games to the more recent version of AGS. Sorry, that's all I can say. Yes, I'm a doctor.
Yes, I am. My coat? It's,
I still laugh
right,
at
I'm not a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
So, Susan, could you tell me what brought you here?
I don't know. They think I'm crazy.
Are you? Crazy, I mean.
I don't know.
I remember Jenna Staris recording these lines literally the day before I launched the game. I wouldn't do that now, but it was kind of a guerrilla fly-by-night operation back then. I remember she came over, she recorded it, and I spent all night editing it and play-tested the game one more time before releasing it. Yeah. Things were a lot different back then.
Who is the deacon?
What do you mean?
The deacon, Susan.
He's nobody. Nobody.
Do you know anything about... Susan?
They...
Susan?
Nothing.
Do you know...
Yeah.
Do you know why she did it?
No.
Okay. That's impressive last minute work. I didn't procrastinate. Actually, it's just the exact opposite of procrastinating. It's that I was determined to get the game out by the day I promised it. I promised to get it out, I don't remember. It was a day in December, and come hell or high water, I was going to hit that date. And I nearly killed myself. Like, I didn't sleep. So it wasn't like I put off doing her voice recording. It's that I was struggling to get everything done on time. Because I only gave myself 4 months to make this game from, like, design to release. And this is why I don't announce release days or estimated launch times until I really, really know that it's time. I'm fine. I'm probably going to be stopping soon because my wife is getting my daughter from daycare and it's like 3 blocks away. So in about 15 minutes, I'm probably going to have to stop because my daughter will be very distracting. But I'm fine. Thank you. I'm still getting over a cold and cough. That ain't going away. And I'm trying to remember how to get Susan to trust you.
I'd like to talk to you about your friend Joanne.
You know Joanne?
Sort of.
What about her?
Can you tell me about her?
She's... that's all.
And I'm trying to pronounce her name. Lord... Kikuchiyu? I'm just guessing.
Do you know why Joanne killed herself? Susan?
She just did. Don't know why.
Can you tell me anything about Alex?
He... I don't know. He's nobody. Just some guy.
Susan, can you tell me why you're here? What happened?
Nothing. Just... nothing.
Susan, can you tell me why you're here? What happened?
Not just...
oops, okay. You can ask about Ouija boards. Okay, I need to ask about
the
deacon and Ouija boards. And the stupid thing is, I did not make this room interactable, which I should have done. I was lazy. I was really lazy. I should have just enabled you to stay in that room so you could do this.
The girls were interested in, and they are all haunted by someone named the Deacon. Could there be a connection?
Yeah, now I gotta go back. Around the
corner.
Whoa!
Hold on there. You wanna go in, I gotta clear you first.
Right.
I'd like to see Susan Lee, please.
Sure thing, you're cleared.
You're cleared.
Go right in.
That's Francisco's, what's his name? Christopher Walken impression. Come in, you're
clear.
Hi,
Susan.
Consult your notes. Deacon
Ouija. Susan, can you listen to me? You're not crazy. I know what happened. You summoned the deacon with a Ouija board.
No, that didn't really happen.
Susan, you don't have to pretend. I believe you.
You do?
Whatever happened, I believe you.
He still comes to me. The drugs keep him away during the day, but when I sleep, he enters my head and he won't stop screaming. I thought I was crazy.
There's a lot of very badly signposted puzzles in this game, Rosella. You're right.
It's impossible.
No,
like I said,
it's not.
No, it's not.
Like I said,
I believe so, yes.
There's a lot of things I would do differently if I could go back in time and do it again.
But,
like I said, this was my first game. I had very little experience and resources, and honestly, this is the best I could have done. So while I give myself a lot of flack, and I've said this a lot, but for the new people who have come to the stream late, I give myself a lot of flack, but I'm well aware that I couldn't have done much better than I actually did.
Can you tell me anything about
Joanne wanted to save the world, but she couldn't
Moo yourself.
Her friends. After Allie went, Joanne couldn't take it. She blames herself, but it's not her fault.
Casting this character was very funny, because I remember meeting Jen
it was only love
and
that I ended up
loving her voice.
Didn't die.
And... she told me she was an opera singer as well, and I just asked if she did voice acting, and she's like, well, I could try. She literally came over that night.
Do you know why Joanne killed...
No, she obviously didn't come over that night, because that was the night before I released the game. It was the week before. I wasn't that bad. That would be crazy.
I just wanted quiet. Peace and quiet. That's why Joanne jumped off the roof. She was willing to give anything to just keep him quiet. Even her life.
Alright,
we've already established this. So what happened to you, Susan? What did the deacon do to you?
The same thing he did to the others. Got into my head and just wouldn't keep quiet. It was just so noisy inside my head. I had to do something. I saw the speeding taxi, and I just... well, you know, here I am.
Were you hurt?
No. The driver hit the brakes in time. Taxi missed me completely. Then the stupid cop on the corner dragged me here. Can't even kill myself right.
Honestly, there is no rhyme or reason to who comes back as a ghost. I think Joanne just had nothing holding her back, so she didn't come back as a ghost. While Allie did, she felt she still had something she wanted to do. She didn't want to leave that dog park, so she stayed. That's how I always approach it. Not everyone comes back as a ghost, otherwise they'd be seeing ghosts everywhere.
Can you tell me about Allie?
Allie. Oh, I miss her so much. The sweetest, funniest person in the world. You couldn't help but smile with her around.
Oh.
She was always dragging us out on some adventure. She was so different.
You are talking too much. All
right. I have to go back.
I was thinking about the puzzles that made me mad once I got the answer. Lots of adventure games. Oh, thank you. I always try to approach things very logically. It's mostly because I hate...
It's starting to get dark.
Yeah, I can see that. Was it the darkness that gave it away?
I'm just saying.
That line was ad-libbed by Abe. He came up with that. You can thank him for that. But yeah, to go back, what I was saying is that I hate illogical puzzles in adventure games. Of course, no one likes them. But people often think that you need to have something and often will make some crazy-ass puzzle because you feel like you need it. But I don't like them in other games, so I don't put them in mine.
Hold on.
All right, All right, let's talk to Susan again. Excuse me. Storm is coming, so you better get in.
Hi, Susan.
Hi. It's good to see you again.
Give
How
me
are
diuretics.
You now?
It's nice to know I'm not crazy.
Yeah, that's...
It's just... these drugs. The meds help keep the deacon's voice low, and that's good. But they also cause water retention, and I have to take a diuretic pill to fix that, and I'm just sick of peeing all the time. Now that I know I'm just haunted and not really crazy, I don't see why I have to take it.
You don't feel like...
I don't care if I retain water and get fat.
Have I played Kathy Rain? You could say I played Kathy Rain. I did the voice acting for it. I directed all the voice acting.
Is she for
real? So yes, I've played Kathy Rain.
Is that bad?
I can't answer that.
Well, I was hoping you could do...
And it looks like a WoW Jedi game because it's used several of our artists. It used the same background artist as Resonance.
Fine.
And the same sprite artist, actually. Shane Stevens did the character art and... Naris Krauss did the backgrounds, and I did the voice acting. So yeah, it there's a lot about Kathy Rain that would remind you of one of ours. All right, so now did I take the pills? Yes, I did. Okay.
I have to go now, Sue. But
Kathy Rain was pretty neat. It was a neat game. Here's a diuretic pill. All right, let's go drug a dog. I don't know. You'd have to ask him. I don't know about sprite making. He already had a publisher, Rosella. It was published by Raw Fury. They had a lot more resources than me, so I was very willing to let them handle it. Whoops.
Welcome back, Rose. Come in.
Poison the pup.
Are you all right, Rosa? You look... I'm... That's... Moti never acted.
Oh, in case you haven't noticed, some animals can sense me. Are you getting a good look, mutt? Boo!
What's gotten into you, Moti?
It's all right.
I still think that's really funny. Oh, I need to ask Nishanti for another dog biscuit, right?
Could I feed Moti another treat?
Sure. Here, take another. I have plenty. Well, take care, Ro. Come back.
Let's go drug a dog, he exclaimed with unusual enthusiasm. Nothing unusual about that enthusiasm.
Okay.
This is such a psychotic puzzle. Hey, where's the dog? Come here, Moti.
Here, boy. Go get it.
Oh, Moti, now? I just took you out an hour ago. Well, you're going to have to wait. I have my hands totally full. If you're going to be friends, this is a good opportunity for...
Oh, sure. I don't mind.
Thank you so much. Moti, just...
And she completely ignores the dog leash.
Right.
Because I did not want to code that.
You're drugging innocent dogs now?
It's only a mild diuretic. It won't hurt him. And you're the one in such a damn hurry.
All right. Point taken.
At least Joey calls you on
hey
it,
there,
right?
Bright Eye. It's me again.
Are you him?
No, I'm not, but I've brought
some
friends.
Oh, wow. Now that I have my headphones on, I could hear...
Say hi to the kids,
I remember...
Sweetheart.
This is a strange bit of trivia. I had a laptop back then that would overheat a lot, and the fan would scream.
Tell Ellie how much you want to
and
see.
During voice recording, it was kind of a problem.
To meet you.
I could hear in my headphones...
Believe you.
Yep. When Ellie talks, I can hear my old laptop's fan... screaming.
See the dog over there?
It's very subtle, but it's there.
Boston Terrier?
Yep.
Good.
I don't know if you guys can hear it, but I can.
This Boston Terrier is not feeling...
It's so subtle.
I was hoping that you could take a look at him.
Yes. Yes, I can.
That's so funny.
I know a lot about dogs.
It's like I'm peering into the past.
That's why we
came to you.
Literally,
I'm looking at my old game.
But they won't let me help them. They always run away.
I put the bill in right in front of her.
The dog needs you.
You're totally right. So I should have had her call you on that. That's really funny.
Sort of.
You're right.
Hey, little guy. What's your name? Right. Are you... Not... That's... I don't feel anything. I...
That wind I used in all five games.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
There is that little fee. You're
I'm
right.
Dead.
That's exactly it.
Yep.
I killed myself. I had no choice.
I used a I used a background noise
My
filter on it.
I
didn't do any processing for Blackwell Legacy. I didn't use any of that.
Fun.
Actually no, Nishanti was washing the dishes.
Yes.
She was turned away from you. So she didn't see you. Though Rosa could have been a little more stealthy about it, but she's not terribly stealthy.
His voice in my head.
I mean, look at her shoes.
Screaming.
What did he say?
I don't know. He just kept asking me to help him. But he wouldn't say how. I tried ignoring him. But he just got louder and louder and...
All right.
Now. Here. Take this.
And hold on tight.
And hold on tight.
I love the way he delivers these lines.
You ready?
I guess so.
Good.
I meant the ghost going into Rosa effect got much more interesting later. And I still love the sound of Rosa falling on her butt.
Hello?
Yeah, hi!
I'm not
She's
sure
so perky.
Met. I'm Rosangela.
Oh my god.
I know! You brought the dog to me! You brought me, and then you brought me here! Thanks so much!
So, are you ready to, well, you know.
Am I ready to die?
Well, yeah. Sorry, I'm kind of new at this.
That's okay. I'm going to make it easy for you.
Well,
just tell me what to
do. It's funny.
Just head
towards that
light.
This game is so rough around
the
edges, but I am smiling while I play it. I don't know why.
Like every cliche in the book. You think I'll see Joanne over there?
Positive.
Sure you will.
Excuse me.
And hey, you'll make sure Susan's okay, right?
Sure.
Well, here goes.
I like this
ya.
Music. Wow, this is lovely. Whoa, spinny. I later on got lazy and just had the characters move backward and shrink.
Ugh.
You're awake.
Oh, crap. That wind sound didn't turn off.
She just
I really hope
went.
That sound doesn't
she
keep going for the rest
it.
Of the game.
Yeah, sometimes you'll get easy ones. The ones who are all too happy to move on. Others, well, you'll see. Anyway, let's get this dog back before your neighbor calls the police. Our work is not over yet.
Oh, good.
She is
okay.
So going to kill
I
me.
I can live with the wind playing for the rest of that scene.
Just somehow you a made minute. A unique
experience that tops off any other adventure game. Thank you, oh. Chaos Origin.
Oh, there you are.
Sorry, I don't mean to laugh at the name, but it's...
I was just about to go to bed.
It's a, such a it so sincere statement, worry. And yet I refer to you as Monty? Chaos Origin.
Did you have fun? Of course. Well, good night, Rosa.
Is that one that goes
through
the game?
I do, actually,
yeah. I think really things really came together for...
Strange lady.
Convergence, and especially Deception. I think Convergence is where I figured things out kind of stylistically. Deception is where I really figured things out in terms of characters, in terms of who they really were, what made them tick. I think Convergence is where I began to figure it out, and Deception is where I really hit the ground running in terms of what the characters wanted and what drove them. And then, of course, the one game later, I ended it. So, I do love the ghost facing through effect you have in later games. How long was Rosa out? Not long. All good. Too many chaos people. It's just hard to sound really sincere when I use the name, like, thank you, Chaos Origin. Anyway, where am I going next? To the hospital.
Please be advised that visiting hours
are now over. Guess what voice actor that was?
Like we have no room. Wait,
what?
Sure.
How?
That's what.
All right, not a distracted guard. This puzzle's a bit annoying because Joey moves around on his own. In later games, if you were able to control Joey, you'd be able to just move him in front of the thing, and it would be fine. But come on, Joey, move to the radio. Come on, Joey. No! Other way! Oh my god, the devil voice. I forgot I did that. I really forgot I did that. I do need to probably... There we go. Get the key.
Fuse box key? I could probably...
Wait, pick it up!
I don't think I need...
Wait. Oh, whoa. Okay. Where is it? I think Rosa thinks I have it. Maybe the game thinks I have it already. That's weird.
You need a key to open.
Oh, crap. I think I found a bug. I found a bug. Yay. All right.
Fuse box key. I could probably.
Okay, there we go. Okay, yeah. If the inventory is scrolled too much, the key won't appear in the inventory. I gotta mark that down. Darn it. Okay. Scroll bar and key inventory. Oh, yeah, Joey completely phases through the door there by accident, but. That's a loud door slamming sound.
Now you've done. You better find a.
Let's see if this puzzle works. Yep. Crying. Love crying.
She's asleep.
Yeah, like a baby. It won't be long.
Before what?
Before that.
Photoshop. What is it called? The outline illumination tool.
Please. Can't you help me? Please.
The deacon was played by another guy from my improv group.
I don't know what to do.
Actually, the head of our improv group. His name is John Swist.
Please.
And
the others are gone.
Amazing, brilliant, brilliant guy who... I have sadly really fallen out of touch with. Although, weirdly enough, I used him as the basis for Peter Fielding in Blackwell Epiphany. So he looks, basically, I wanted like a really, really fit guy in his late 50s, and that is John Swist. So Peter Fielding looks like John Swist. Let him rant. Forceful interjection.
Hey!
Ignore them, Susan. Listen to me.
And I did not process him at all.
Please.
He's got more breath pops than anyone.
I'm talking to you, clown shoes.
Clown shoes? What the? Sorry. I'm a little punchy now. I'm like, what? I've been at this for, almost 3 hours. Holy crap.
Tell me what's going on.
I can't. You're like me.
What do you mean?
Dead. Like me.
Wait a minute. Just a goddamn minute. You know you're dead?
Yes.
Well, that certainly saves time. We can help you. Here, grab a hold of this.
No. Get that.
What the hell is wrong with you? You need saving. We're here to save you. What's the problem?
The problem.
I can't.
What are you... You're...
No.
John Swiss is a very good actor. He also played Joel DeMarco in The Shiva, the guy who attacks you on the subway.
I'm afraid.
I'm afraid. Oh, I think I hear my daughter.
You believe this guy?
What do you want?
Safety. Sanctuary. It's following me.
Police sirens outside. Not part of the game.
Yeah, let me handle this baby doll. I know how to speak to spooks like this.
What hasn't caught you?
It. I. What?
This. You're too.
Alright, who is after
Who is
him?
It?
Haven't you ever seen him?
Forget it, kid. He isn't listening.
The shift is not very long.
He
gets through in half hour, so.
We don't need kid gloves to handle this. Let me take.
Sure.
Alright, Mac. Spill. You've scared these girls literally to death, and I want to know why. What are you so afraid of?
I.
Burn. Oh, you think you're going to hell?
The devil himself. He told me. Please don't make me go.
If you read Joe Gould's secret,
you'll
learn where I got the idea from the deacon.
I don't see any devil. There's just you and me. And you know what? I'm worse than any devil you'll ever see.
Damn, Abe.
I've been doing this for 40 years, bucko. Every ghost I meet goes to their final rest, one way or the other. You're scared? I don't give a rat's ass.
God damn, Joey's
two people are dead.
Nasty in this game.
So take the damn tie,
man.
And let's get this over with.
Gosh, wow. This shocked even me. I don't remember Joey being
please.
This nasty.
Hurts, don't it? Ghosts aren't supposed to feel pain, but I've learned some tricks. Now take the damn tie.
Joey, stop it.
You want to handle this? Go right ahead. Let's see you do any better.
2 hours, really? Did you get stuck, or have you been progressing in the game? Try and give hope.
I know a safe place. You can hide there.
Really? Where is it?
Not far, but you'll have to trust us.
Trust you? Why should I trust you?
Because you care about others?
Because we don't want you to kill anyone else.
They weren't my fault. They just wouldn't listen to me. Why don't they want
to
help me?
I forget how to solve this puzzle.
Nobody wants to help me. You're a liar.
All right. Your way isn't working. So, are we going to do this the easy way? Or the hard way?
Please. What are you going to... Please. I don't...
Hell sh...
Hey, stop.
I'm sorry I'm skipping lines. I want to kind of get through this before my daughter comes home. Give her
you
a chance.
Go right. Let's see you do any better.
I spent at least 15 minutes waiting for Rosa to say everything in the bar. That was fun to do. Because you care about others. Talk about running.
You can't keep going on like this.
It's better than burning.
Uh-huh, yeah, you had your shot. Now it's mine.
Well, I screwed that up.
I don't believe in hell, buddy. But you have two choices. The slight possibility, or the...
But...
Sure, I... You could make...
I
make wrong answer.
Pow!
You're hurting him, Joey.
Yeah, that's the idea. You got any better one?
Let me talk to him.
You want to handle this?
Wow, okay.
All right. Let's see.
You know, this is a very common thing. I know that in Babylon 5, the character of Jakar was really, really nasty in the first couple of episodes. And then he became like this very kind of funny intellectual type in later seasons. As they kind of evolved his character, and you watch some of the early ones, and it's really quite shocking how mean he is.
Because nobody else has offered to help you before, right?
Yeah.
You ask and ask for help, but nobody answers, right?
No. Nobody answers.
Well, we have. We're gonna help you. Has anybody else said the same?
No. No, they haven't. I think... Oh, I'm so tired of running. If you say you
rub your inventory on everything.
What needs to be done?
Just listen
wow,
to my friend.
Wow, that light is bright. I'm trying to maneuver my head so I'm blocking it.
Here, just take the tie. You know what to do. I can't believe she pulled that off.
Ow.
That deadpan delivery makes me laugh every time. Oh boy.
Are you ready?
Yes.
How many people are still in the chat room? 38. Wow. We started off with 50. I know we lost a bunch and then came back up again. So, wow. Thanks for sticking with me, guys.
So.
Hello.
It's really nice out here. Almost like.
Hey, you.
Like.
You stepped in the poop.
At last, I have found you.
No! You lied to me!
What?
Oh no.
It's here!
And I realized
you
it.
Lied.
I just announced that to the
What's
entire
that?
Live stream.
Oh crap! Joey? Joey! Get me out of here!
Stay away! Stay away!
There's nowhere to go.
I don't know what that is.
You cannot return to the mortal world. You can only go through me. Accept the punishments for your sins and come.
Okay.
Can you steal the cookie?
I can open here. You are.
You brought me here.
Here. This is Daddy's game. This is Blackwell.
Fool. No one can save you now.
Here you go.
I'll give you a moment to prepare for the eternity
here,
to come.
Here, you want
to
watch the game?
But then,
you can sit on my lap. Here we go. Getting big.
Oh.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, it's
okay, I'm gonna let's see here.
Here, Dad, he's half like.
Oh, thank you. Okay.
It's good.
Yeah.
Dad, is that your new microphone?
Yeah, this is the new microphone.
Did it get equipped?
Hmm?
Did it get equipped?
It's new. It works.
This
straight
is
denial.
Not happening.
Okay, a little distracted now, guys. Sorry.
The
broken one is up in the bedroom shelf. Yeah. Hey, could you tell the live stream what happened to the old microphone?
Uh huh.
What happened to the old microphone?
I touched it.
You what?
I touched it.
You touched it, and what happened?
It broke.
It broke. Yep. Someone broke my old microphone.
Please.
Oh, whoops. Okay, I need to save the deacon, don't I?
I lost a different game.
No, we're watching this one.
What is that in your pocket?
My flask.
Yeah, what's in it?
Nothing. It's just a force. Used to keep whiskey in it.
This is that big thing.
That's a demon.
What is
he
that thing?
Look mad. Doesn't look mad.
He doesn't look mad? I think he looks pretty mad.
There's no...
So what can I do?
Oh,
what
she's eating a cookie. Maybe
he
I shouldn't have done that.
Me.
Sorry, leave it to Daddy. I know you have to run to get to the thing, so I'll handle everything. I can handle that. Yep. Okay, whoops.
What is
like
that?
A
nothing.
It looks like a sandwich, yeah.
It's just a...
I'm
habit,
I guess.
Yeah, sorry.
Whiskey in it.
Are you okay?
Alive. Yes.
Evie, why don't you eat it? Don't play with it.
I want to play the part.
You what?
I'm playing the part.
You're playing the part?
I'm breaking the part.
You're breaking it. Okay.
Wait.
Excuse me.
Converse with me not. I shall give him but...
Why are you after him?
For his sins.
All right, here you go.
All this time.
Okay, kid.
That's not
okay. Here we go. Okay.
Uh-oh. Even
watch
after
watch
these many years of...
Whoa! Someone almost broke another microphone. Here we go. Okay, let me plug this back. Okay.
How did you get
Sorry about that.
What is here? It is but an abstract concept. To I once my business.
Oh my god, that's my voice. That's my voice.
I shall trouble you no more.
Can't you just let him go?
He has killed many with his magic.
Shinigami.
His sins weigh him to ask yourself. Does he deserve mercy?
Yes.
Yes?
You may think so, but your heart does not believe it. You have witnessed the results of his actions.
I remember thinking this demon voice effect was a lot more impressive back in 2006. Now that I've worked with, like, actual audio engineers, I think in the notes, yep, here we go, link the two.
The deacon is carrying his sins, and the deacon is, could this be symbolic?
Why is she angry? Why are you so angry, Rosa?
Get rid of that flask.
Huh?
Your flask, get rid of it.
My flask? Why?
Just do it.
But I can't.
Why not?
Because it's my flask.
You want to be free of that demon?
That's correct. A lot of people thought it was a real demon when it never was. And I'm really sorry if I gave that impression.
You no longer
it was always supposed to be metaphorical.
But they still taint this place. That is not enough to see.
Yeah, I'm almost done with the game, but Eve can sit on my lap while I play it. Yeah, come on.
It is done. The sins have been abolished from this place.
He's gone?
I think so.
He's gone. I'm free of him. I'm really free. All this time.
Is this just chat knowing a bunch of bugs?
It's all so clear to me now. Like my head was full of cobwebs and now they're gone. All those people who died.
Wow, this stream lasted almost 3 hours.
It's all right.
No. It's not
actually 2.5, because we had that issue with the audio at the beginning. Doing,
but that doesn't excuse
hooray! Thanks, 1Kevin888. The demon is your voice. Yeah, I modulated a little bit. I think I lowered the pitch by like 20% and I added an echo. And I talk like this.
Now that I know I might deserve it.
Maybe you can still redeem yourself.
Maybe. Eventually. But not right now. You see, I was a religious man once, before disease took my wife away, and I took to the bottle. If I'm going to hell, well then maybe I can still spread the word of God there. Do some good for once. Well, this is it. Goodbye, and thanks.
And the deacon smile, which is the only time you see it. Uh-oh.
Jesus Christ, kid, you all right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's funny, he talks about religion, and then Joey, when you wake up, Joey says Jesus Christ.
It got a little complicated.
Well, I'm just glad you're okay.
Let's get out of here. I need some air.
I know the perfect place.
He's at peace now, I guess. Wherever he is. I saved him, I think. Gave him some hope, at least.
He's getting no more than he deserves. No more than any of us deserve.
I guess.
I really wished I could have popped him one more time. He really hacked me off.
Is that your answer to everything?
Don't you start judging me. You managed to pull it off. I'm impressed. I'm just glad you're okay.
Joey?
Yeah?
Why did Auntie stop?
Stop what?
Stop doing this. This ghost saving or whatever it is we do.
Oh. Ah.
Thank you.
It was you.
Me?
You're free, but don't have whiskey anymore?
Wanted to do it right,
I actually do have whiskey in the kitchen.
Stop listening to me. Stop
I might have
saving
some.
The ghosts. Just put all her effort into taking care of you.
And then she.
Oh, you mean the deacon doesn't have
coma.
Whiskey anymore? Yeah. You're right.
I see.
He is going to hell.
I guess there's a lesson in that.
Is there?
Hey, kiddo.
Yeah.
Hey, just in time. Credits. No, you weren't born. You weren't born yet.
I'm coming in.
Whoa. You don't want to? Okay, alright.
You still live streaming?
It's over. It's, what is it, kid?
I think so.
You just got home. in 5 minutes, okay? All right, guys. You can save the deacon, and you can also if you take too long, he kind of gets his soul gets burnt. Anyway, I hate to cut and run, but my daughter's here and kind of needs attention, so the timing is kind of perfect. Thank you all for joining me. She's there. They are right there. Eve, can you? You want to wave?
Wave
right there. Yep, there she is. All right, kiddo. All right, I got a jet. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye-bye. All right, cut this off. All right, how do I do this? Ah!